You better come on.
Hello, Tom.
Five albums, one legendary record label. The name of the band? OZone. Motown initially used OZone as backing musicians for artists, including Billy Preston, Syreeta, and Tina Marie, before allowing them to record the first of five albums in 1980. Rick James and Tina Marie used them extensively on their projects, including Behind the Groove, Square Biz, I Need Your Lovin', Portuguese Love, and Fire and Desire. Motown released their first album, Walk On. A song from that album appeared on the soundtrack for the movie, It's My Turn, an instrumental track that showcased the band's musical prowess. They performed the song on the television show, The Midnight Special, hosted by Wolfman Jack. The name of the song was Walk On, and the band received their first taste of chart success. The subsequent albums, Jump On It, Send It, Lil Susie, and Glasses, yielded more radio hits. Songs like Lil Susie, Strut My Thang, and Jigolette proved that this band was here to stay.
Strut! Are y'all ready to strut? Say it! Let me hear you say it. I want all the ladies to sing it. Fellas, strut! We'll see y'all later. Come on, let me hear you. Everybody, everybody, let me see you say, OZone, 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 OZone. Let's scream! Good night, y'all.
I'm good.
How you doing?
Hey, bro, we hanging in there, man. Hanging in another day.
Putting some lotion on my hands, man. I'm all the time. I get ashy.
Yeah, we get ashy, bro. That's part of the heritage. Part of the heritage, man.
Yeah, man.
So we on here. We on here today. We on here. With the blues and funk legends, Tony T.C. Coleman, and me,
hey,
and Waldo.
Hey.
Yeah, man, we hanging in there. Hard day of work today. make a dollar and a quarter. I know Tony Coleman don't know nothing about this. He make $340,000. I make a dollar and a quarter. Where you at today, man? Where you at today?
I'm in the parking lot of a old Toys R Us building that's out of business. Big Toys R Us, so seems appropriate for me to be over here at the Toys R Us. Toys is Us.
When they out of business? When they go out of business?
Man, it's a lot of businesses gone out of business since COVID, man.
Toys R Us, oh, man. I said big
why
dollar
you,
thing.
Why are you out of business?
I ain't out of business. I'm still working, bro.
Music business. Why are we out of business?
Well, I don't know, but I think there's some bullshit behind it. I ain't going to lie about it. There's some bullshit about it.
Well, whatever the bullshit is, it's working because they sure got me.
Yeah, well, they got us both.
Because I'm getting my second shot tomorrow, so whatever it is, they hooked me in. So hook, line, and sinker, I'm going all the way with it. I ain't going to play around. I ain't going to take no chances. They found the right thing to make me go get a shot. I hate needles.
Hey, bro, that's how come I ain't on drugs. I ain't shoot nothing up in here, bro. If I have to go and take insulin and give myself those diabetic shots, Lord, I don't know what I do.
Really, man.
Yeah, man. So.
But I'm going to Nashville Monday.
Nashville. I ain't been there in about 3 years. And mama died.
Really?
No. I think she died a year before. Four years. But I haven't been back to Nashville in 3 years. Yeah, but I'll get on that train sooner or later. Yeah, so what you going to do in Nashville, man?
I'm going to record with Kenny Wayne Shepherd.
Kenny Wayne Shepherd. He's a country boy, ain't he?
No. He was born a country boy, but he's a rock blues player, you know, young man.
Is that what he's doing now, rock and blues?
That's all he ever done. He ain't never done nothing else.
Really? I always thought he played country.
No.
Oh. Well, I'm wrong again.
See that, man? You are stereotyping folks. See how what you get so used to it happening to you, you end up doing it.
No, I really thought he was country. For some reason,
no.
I don't know why.
No. You country?
Man, rock. Yeah, I got a little country. I got a little country in me. I ain't going to say I don't. And I like it.
I love country music.
Yeah.
I love country music. It's all right with me. I just, some of them assholes that play it, I don't like.
That's true, too.
I'm sure, you know, you can say that about me, too. Oh, I love the blues, but some of them old black assholes I don't like.
Yeah.
And that cop man, Tony Coleman, he's one of them. He's one of them.
There's probably a lot of people saying that.
I'm sure it is.
Yeah.
For different reasons. I got my reasons. I think my reasons are more valid than theirs, though.
Why is that?
Because I hate people that are racist assholes that don't like people because of the color of their skin and their race. And I talk about it and hate me hating them and talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
That's what. I just wish he'd keep his fucking mouth shut. He don't need to be saying shit. Now, I need to tell y'all some assholes for being like that, because black people, we always been inclusive. Welcome. Join us. Have something to eat. Come on, let's party. You're welcome. How you doing? That's the way we are as people. Really, that's who we are. We like to party and have a good time, laugh and talk and make love, and we don't like fighting fuck, but but people keep been poking us forever, so we got a defense mechanism that others don't understand.
I know, that's right.
When you see your ancestors, history of your ancestors getting hung by in trees by till they die, and knees put on their neck for 9 hours while man sit there smiling, that's enough to make you an angry black man. And if anybody don't understand that, I don't give a damn. They like it when you quiet.
That's crucial stuff.
Huh?
That's some crucial stuff. It's about a lot of nothing.
And if I saw somebody doing one of my white friends like that, I'd kick their ass. I got some decent white people in my life who happen to be white, and they're good people. And I love them just like I love my black friends that are good people. But when my black friends do stuff that's ignorant and wrong, I get off in the ass. And when white folks do stuff that's ignorant and wrong, I get off in that ass. But I don't need no white people telling me, you're angry. No, you need to shut the fuck up and listen. You need to be as angry as that shit that's going on up in Minnesota and what's been happening for 400 years. You need to be angry, too, if you say you believe in equal rights and justice.
Mm-hmm.
But don't just be about, don't be mad at me because I'm sick of shit and say I'm an asshole. He's such an asshole being angry about the way we killed a black ass in the street with badges and nothing happened to the murderers. He shouldn't be so angry. He should just shut up and go play his drums and be a happy nigga.
Yeah, a lot of that shit, man. It's crazy in hell.
But
check us out, man.
Yeah.
We got somebody on this mug getting ready to pop in on us. You might even know the man. I think you might even play the show with the cat.
Who you got, man? Who you got? Who you got, Waldo?
You know who Little Richard is? Little Richard.
Little Richard.
Little Richard, Tutti Frutti, old Rudy.
Little Richard, bam, boom, bang, boom, bang, boom, blam, blam, boom,
that's
bang.
That's the one. That's the one. We got him. Look here, we got him, bass player.
He is one.
Grew up in Nashville, Tennessee.
He is one fine bass player too, and he's a fine gentleman. I know about him.
Well, I ain't going that far. But anyway, I helped raise him up. Me and his daddy was good friends.
Well, put the man on so we can see him, man. Put him on so we can see him, man.
Put him on. You want to talk about
man,
who's
put him on.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Charles Glenn. Charles Glenn in the house.
What's up,
Charles Glenn?
What's up? Well,
what's up, man? You got too much light in your background, Charlie.
Huh?
That big white light in your background. There you go. Thank you very much, sir.
That better?
What's going on with you, man?
Oh, not much, man. Just listening to y'all talk about, y'all's thing.
I ain't talking about nothing, man. Just talking about the way it is.
Yeah.
The way it is.
What's going on, Charles?
Nothing. This boy, I see this boy lost his mind this morning at the Capitol, so it ain't stopped.
You know what I'm saying? You don't know about that, Tony?
No, I didn't. I've been on appointments all morning. What happened?
Man. Dude. Tell him, Charles.
Looked like this guy took a car and ran up into the Capitol with a car. He ran over a cop and killed him, and then he jumped out the car and knew they was gonna kill him, and of course they did. And so he ran over a cop in the car, killed him, and like he was trying to drive up he's gonna break the barriers or something, drive up to the Capitol. So he killed a cop, and then he jumps out the car, and then cops shot him and stuff. So
he had a knife too or something, didn't he?
Huh?
Yeah, killed him.
Yeah, they killed
him. He had a knife.
Yeah,
he came out of the car with a knife.
What was his description? Describe him to me.
I say he was like Islam dude. Is that what did they say that? He Aryan Nation guy. He's one of them guys. What was he? I don't want to misquote. But
I don't really know. I don't really know. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. But it's all over the news, man.
Yeah, it's all over the news. All you got to just turn on CNN. They posted right there, like right now.
I hadn't been watching the news this morning. Ain't that a trip?
So it's all good.
Yeah, man.
I have to give myself a break sometime from it, because all I do is get either extremely, extremely mad or extremely sad.
Yeah.
Hey, man. Glenn, Mr. Glenn.
Yes.
I got a question for you.
Okay.
Why y'all put y'all foot so deep in our ass when we open with y'all, man, with Little Richard Band?
Boss Man wanted it that way.
Why y'all do that to us, man?
Hey, man, Boss Man requested it every
You know, I ain't like that, man. Y'all should be ashamed of yourself for doing people like that, man.
Yeah, it was a bad thing, but
look here, Waldo. Let me tell you. Yeah. Got two drummers.
Yep.
Yeah.
Two bass players.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a boy.
They got one guitar player.
Yeah.
The horn section be on one side playing. They finish playing their horn section. The whole horn section walk over to the other side of the stage. Then that goddamn drummer hit the downbeat. Boom! Both of their ass jump up like jazz.
Yeah. Yeah.
And little Richard, he all he doing is doing. And that's it. And that kicked off. And I ain't never forgot it. I wanted to
teach y'all who you're messing with.
Huh?
Teach you who you're messing with.
Hey, man. Yeah. One of the tightest bands next to James Brown Band that I've ever seen. Now, don't mind you. B.B. King, and we wasn't no slouches.
No,
we
y'all
just
wasn't. No. Nope.
Y'all wasn't no slop. Y'all wasn't no slop, bro. Y'all were doing what you do.
Yeah.
But
doing what you do on the one.
I'm telling you, man, I enjoy that so much, man. We toured together. Bet your phone didn't sound that loud. Hey, man,
what you don't know. It's Tony works for the railroad.
Okay.
And he out there making that big money.
Making that big money.
As I come in here and I hear the whistle blowing.
Yeah, well, he got the time.
Hey, man, look here to hell with all that, Waldo. Let me talk about that ass whooping they gave us.
Go ahead. You can't get it out of your mind, can you?
Hell.
Look here. We toured together. The Kings of Rock and Roll Tour. Little Richard, B.B. King, Jerry Lee Lewis, and Chuck Berry.
Chuck Berry, yep.
Man, that's some historical shit. We should be respected for who we are, back them guys up, just for that alone.
That's true.
I mean, why we don't get the same credit as white people that play our music, I'm sick of that, man. It hurts so much to think that white musicians who play blues music and rock and roll are millionaires, and we just here.
Yeah, that's something to think about.
Yeah.
And I'm tired of people being upset when my black ass talk like I talk. Because I'm 65. The rest of my life, I'm going to be talking like this. Because you know what? It is important that we, as a race of people, start doing our own things and promoting our own shit. Or shut the hell up about things that you ain't getting right. I mean, reversing. Things are reversing now. And everybody's trying to keep you quiet. Shh. In Georgia, all those black people voted. Now they got rules that you can't even make a person a bottle of water to drink. You go to jail for being in the line. Come on, man. There's some racist shit going on in this country. And I'm not going to be quiet about it no more. And I'm going to figure out how to be an activist to change these things. We shouldn't have to kill somebody to make them do the right thing. And black musicians, see, because black musicians been putting their knee on our neck forever, man.
Yeah.
They ain't never paid us the money we deserve and give us the acknowledgement we deserve. We some bad motherfuckers, okay?
Yeah.
And if you think the Who is bad and the Rolling Stones is bad, well, we the reason for all that shit. So
yeah.
Nobody else wanna give us credit. Charles is a bad motherfucker. Waldo Weathers is a bad motherfucker. And Tony T. Coleman, I'm a bad motherfucker. And if I get pissed off about me being the way I am right now, I'm tired of the quiet shit. I ain't going to kill nobody. I ain't going to blow nothing up. I ain't going to burn nobody. But I'm going to keep talking about it until either something happens or, you know, just shut the hell up and don't do nothing, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I know it, man. It's a crazy thing, man. Really
one
crazy
thing
thing.
I give country musicians credit for. Jamie John and those guys, Vince Gill and those guys, they acknowledge their elders who came before them. They acknowledge them, and they respect them.
If I want to
go see Bruno Mars, I got to get somebody looking at me like I'm begging for something. Who is you, BB? Who? What?
Yeah.
James Brown? We're the greatest entertainers, the three entertainers in the world. Us. Little fucking Richard. James Goddamn Brown. BB Mars.
These are the greatest.
They don't
time.
Know.
Look at this.
They don't know.
Wait a minute. Let me see. Hold on a second. Let me see if I can flip this. No, that ain't it. I didn't do it. Camera. Can I flip my camera? Well, I'll just turn it around.
Yeah, there he is. Look at him.
All three of them.
Well, that's two we did, man.
Yeah, that's
right. Take a picture of that and send it to me, please.
Will do. Will do, because that's what
hey,
that's
man,
the from.
The only one missing up there is James Brown.
Yeah, uh-huh.
Yeah, I don't know why
And I have to always put my, I have to always put myself out here and.
Wait a minute, we did something with.
What
with
I
yeah.
We did something with Richard.
Yeah, yeah, I did. Yeah, because I had to go to fucking James's dressing room to see what kind of shoes he had on. Charles, do me a favor. No, go see what James's shoes is. Because see, you can go around there. You got on the clothes for it.
So, and the stage managers got into an argument.
Yes. Yes,
and almost into a fight
with
because
the
they were talking about
all of that. Yeah,
the microphone stand.
Yeah.
And who was going to come on first?
Yep,
who was going to come on first? They had a big. I remember that, man.
Yeah,
they sure did. Had a big thing, boy. Yeah,
James Brown. Little Richard was, y'all was bad, but James Brown deserved to headline any show. Now, that's
yes.
My James Brown band deserved to show any show. But I tell you right now, if James Brown was A, Little Richard was A+. Wasn't no B.
No, wasn't no B's, yeah. Was it?
So the only thing they should have done was co-headline, as they say, one open one night, one open the next night.
Yeah.
But every time I've been on the show with James Brown, like I was telling Waldo about the time they had James Brown, B.B. King, Wilson Pickett, and Bobby Blue Bland. Now, the order of the show should have been, in my opinion, Bobby Blue Bland, he would open the show because Bobby don't care. Bobby be like, hey, man, I get my money, I play it, I'm going home.
Yeah,
so Bobby Blue Bland opened the show. Then it should have been Wilson Pickett, then B.B. King and James Brown. But then since Wilson Pickett was raised so much, B.B. was like, hey, I'm going after Bobby up before Bobby. I got my money, whatever. So now you got a fight between James Brown and Wilson Pickett. And James Brown said, you know you shouldn't go on going after me. Ain't no reason for that. I got just hit you got. Hey, you ain't know what I did. I got the hits.
You ever
heard
this? I got the whips, Mr. Pickett. the only real big hit you got is people not a horse, Mustang Sally.
That's
right. No, Mr. Brown, man, y'all lost that ass, in my opinion. But the later versions of his band weren't as bad as the original one, like Maceo Fred, Chicken,
yeah,
Cheese. Y'all weren't tight as them, although y'all was awesome, but y'all weren't tight as them, brother. Those were the original guys.
Yeah.
Y'all didn't have that stank like them all, though. Y'all didn't have that on.
Yeah, but we kicked anybody's ass that was up there. I tell you that.
Where'd it go? Am I still here?
You still, yeah, but you in the dark.
I know, I can't find it. I can't find it.
Where'd you go?
You done?
I don't know what happened.
You done flipped.
I pushed.
You done flipped your camera.
Huh? I pushed something. I don't know what I pushed.
It's your camera.
Yeah, once
button.
You get on here, don't hit the camera. In the camera. Cam. There you go.
There you go.
Now don't touch nothing else no more. You know, I know you kind of hot here. You don't take instructions well.
That's how come we played the Richard's music like that, because I was gonna bring my own version. I'm bringing my own version. I don't care whose songs it is. Waldo, you know that.
Did you?
Yeah.
How long did you play with Mr. Richard?
About 35 years.
How long?
35 years. About 32 years.
You were in L.A. before when you joined him, right?
Yeah, I joined him when the Down and Out in Beverly Hills, when he did that movie. I went to a session with Billy Preston. I was with Billy Preston first. And Billy Preston. Yeah, we was Billy had a session with Richard for the Down and Out in Beverly Hills movie, the song they did, Great God Almighty, they wrote together.
Did you play Billy Preston band when the Brothers Johnson was his rhythm section?
No, that was before me. That's who, actually OZone. We replaced the Brothers Johnson with Billy.
Yeah, the Brothers Johnson. That was one of their first big gigs. We get back in the Billy Preston.
Yeah, it was.
Hey, Tony. You should have seen it. You should have seen it back in 1976. We went to A&M studio.
Oh,
we were supposed to be auditioning to play with the Silvers, I think it is.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
The Bars, yeah. So we get there and go in this big-ass sound stage. Huge. I mean, fucking huge.
Yeah.
And man, Tony, I tell you no lie, the stage looked like somebody like Queen or Jethro Tull. Man, it was amps from the bottom of the stage down to the top of the ceiling. Yeah. And I'm talking about a good 16, 20 feet.
Yeah.
All the way across from one side to the other.
Yep.
one was guitar amps and the other ones was bass amps.
Yep.
So we're standing down there in the sound room waiting. Then Lewis came. So then we talk a little bit. Then he take his bass out. They give it to try this system out. You know, this cat done bought this system in for them to try out to take on tour. Bro, he got pissed off because his wife put the wrong bass in the car. He got about 20 basses and she put the wrong one in the car. But you remember that, y'all?
Yeah.
So anyway.
Who's this?
Lewis Johnson.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Brother Johnson. So he started playing around with the amps and stuff. And so then all of a sudden, Charles, the new kid on the block, the baby of the group, he takes his bass out. And all of a sudden, Charles and Louis Johnson are on the stage just rattling the whole building. I mean, man, it was sound, it was bass, like you ain't never heard. Like you ain't never, ever heard, man.
I love it.
It was
ridiculous. Y'all had a little duel, huh?
Yeah, that was pretty exciting. that was my dude right there. I'm like, oh shit. Yeah. I said, well, I have my bass.
Hey, Charles.
Huh?
We did cool jazz festivals. BBK, Bobby Blue Bland, Luke Brothers Johnson, The Emotions, The OJs, Lou Donaldson, who else was on that particular bill? You know, you remember the cool jazz?
Yeah.
So it'd be different artists, you know, like different. You have Cameo, Rufus and Chaka Khan, you know, Chaka Khan, Dionne Warwick, New Birth Band, you know, all that. Anyway, but this particular day, Brother Johnson was headlining. The emotions was coming on before them. They had a bass player named Chuckaluck out of Chicago. You know Chuckaluck?
You going out again, Charlie? There you go. You back on. Go ahead, Tony.
You know Chuckaluck?
Mm-hmm. I'm good.
Go ahead.
We're losing you.
Go ahead, Tony.
When I went out.
Did you hear me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Old Chuckaluck put something on Louis Johnson's ass that night. Where'd you go, man?
We're right here.
I'm right here.
We're here. We listen to you.
Oh. No, I'm saying, so emotions gave old Chuckaluck a solo, man. He was like Louis Johnson on steroids, man. He was killing, bro. I always liked the fact that we compete no matter who we are with each other. And those are some of the best shows in the world because those shows aren't pre-recorded or pre-programmed.
No.
Every show, you don't know what's going to happen the next
time. Right. That's right.
If somebody, you cannot set your watch to the shows we did. Because you don't know what the front man going to call out that night.
They have no idea.
You just be ready. You keep this close and these open.
That's right.
Because they throw back their hand. You got to figure out what key it is.
Yep.
And be ready. Bam. Be right on it.
Right on it, too.
Yeah.
That's entertainment. On it. Recorded, playing with tracks. That's all the bullshit, man. The audience is getting cheated. The audience is getting cheated. You're not getting talent. You're getting a band with training wheels on it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Band on the track.
Band on the track.
Yeah.
That's good. I like that. Band on the track.
Band on the track. If it's a figure eight, that's all you're going to see is a figure eight all night.
That's it.
People go to the day, they say, oh, it was a great show. The production was amazing. The drum kit went upside down on a roller coaster. I'm talking. All the stage lift up and went to the outside of the building and came back in the building. What the fuck?
Oh, God.
Hey, man, did you see that pyro, man? I've never seen that much pyro in my life.
Yep.
Richard
would say that on stage. No, we don't use none of that stuff. We don't use no stuff. Ain't nothing gonna blow up. Nothing. We just getting ready to light you up. We don't let that get ready to blow up. That's what he would say.
Heart and soul, baby. Heart and soul.
Yes.
Albertine, you be up there like Inspector Clouseau trying to find what key he playing in.
Yeah.
He'd be slamming the notes you ain't even heard. He'd be playing in between notes. God damn, what the hell was that? What the hell that was? What time done?
Shit. Yeah, let's just like Jane Brown. You know, we got our show, structured, but we don't know what really the next song is.
Yeah.
until we get the signal from him. He ain't going to say what the song is. No. We just get a signal. We got to know the signal. And dudes, sometimes he would go back and do a song that we ain't never played.
Yep.
Never, never, ever played. And you, when he counted off, you better play it.
You better play it.
You better play it in the right key, right tempo.
That's
you
right.
Better play it. I ain't never played the song before.
Yep.
And ain't got no charts. The horn players ain't got charts.
No.
Ain't nobody got no charts.
No. It's all ear to ear whispering going on.
Yeah.
And not a lot of that.
No.
And everybody gonna play together in the right key together.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shit, ain't no whispering because we too far apart from each other.
And about a monitor, your ass better pay. You didn't start out with no damn monitors. You didn't have no in ears when you started out. You better your ass pay.
Yeah. I never liked those through that. Things.
Me either.
Yeah, they throw
I don't
me
like
off.
Them at all.
It's too close. I don't want that. I don't want to hear a record. I want to hear a live show.
Yeah.
Records. I keep telling people when they start calling, man, you sure had that tempo up because I'm old school. Do not hire me and hold me. You can't. I'm not the one. I'm a thoroughbred. I got to run.
Right. Exactly. Yeah.
You can't stop me from running. When I get on stage, I'm like this, like
yeah.
When you're in the record studio, you're playing a certain tempo to make sure the record works.
Yes.
That's called the recorded version.
That's just the record. That's just to make the record work.
Right.
That shit might not work on stage. You go out there on stage with that slow shit and see what happens.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
If you gotta kick that shit.
If you listen to any one of those people we're talking about, any black musician, especially any black musician, you listen to the record. When you go to the show, let's take any song. It could be a slow song or a fast song. If it's a slow song, it's still gonna push a little bit more.
Yeah.
It ain't gonna be dream or dream. Because you will get somebody will pull a gun and shoot your ass on stage. You better play.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
It's Little Richard saying, on the front. Oh, tootie booty, Rudy, tootie booty. Bop, 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 bang, bang, bang. When you get on stage, shit, that shit gonna be on fire, buddy.
That shit's on fire.
Yeah.
Yep, the record shouldn't be in.
You musicians talking about. Wow, that was sure fast. I did that to BB one time. BB used to play Let the Good Times Roll in a good shuffle. BB had extra Spike Geritol one night. And then you get tired and break that shovel into a bag. Come on, man. And my damn fingers be like that. Locked up.
Yes.
I have to unfill them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then BB. Man, what was. And I say to BB. Man, what happened? That shuffle was so fast tonight. What do you mean, son? Man, it was so fast. My hands locked up. Oh, yeah, locked up, huh? Yeah. Well, I didn't tell you to play drums, son. I'll see you later.
That's good.
That's funny. Didn't see it, player. That's funny.
Yeah, shit. People don't realize how great the guys like that really are or were. I mean, these guys, man, they really come out there, man, and set some boundaries, man. Some serious ones. I mean, Richard would come out on that stage and he would make a decision, and you know, some nights he just didn't feel it and wanted everything slow or whatever. But some nights, man, he'd come out there or y'all would beat and did a good show or something, and he'll look at us and say, "Okay, Overdrive, let's go." And and you know, it's weird because we had two drummers, but he had a reason for that.
Yeah,
it wasn't for louder. It was because It's because one drummer plays really fast, and the other drummer liked to play really slow. In other words, if we did a show with one drummer without the other one, everything would be really fast the whole night. If we did a show with the other drummer without the other one, everything would be really slow, no matter how much we wanted to push it. But together. Together, one wants to go fast, the other one can't go quite as fast, so they meet at a happy medium, and it sets the tempo perfect every night. And Richard was smart enough to have figured that shit out, because he liked the one guy to jump all off the drums and stuff, because he's real hyped. He pushes. But when the other drummer would play by himself, everything would be wop bop loop bop loop bop bop do it, right? It'd be kind of swing, and he couldn't get him to pick it up.
Wow, that's funny.
Yeah.
That wouldn't happen with Brown. You wouldn't be on stage with Brown. Brown would say bye bye. You gonna play it where he wanted, and he got two drummers because, you know, drummers got different feels.
Yeah.
And he might like the feel of this other drummer on another song.
Yeah.
So he cut one drummer off and bring on the other, you know.
Yeah.
And then on some songs, both of them play. But whatsoever you play, you going to play at his tempo.
Yeah.
You going to play at his tempo. He ain't going for that other shit. Mm-mm. No, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Music. Hey, Charlie, tell me what's going on with you, man. What you got going on new?
Well, you know, I got a new Ozone for one, and we're working on new music and, you know, working on a project, trying to get it out there, you know, amongst this different music we got going besides Bruno. And
yeah.
it's a different movement. But you know what, man? I still know that the stuff that we're recording, people are missing. I know people are missing that. They just don't know where to get it. There's no way that a whole fan base of people that like a certain genre of music don't like it anymore. There's no way.
Right.
They're just not getting any of it, or they have to listen to old what you call the old school or whatever to be able to feel like they're getting it. You know, I notice even these new the older cats, when they do new songs now, you know, they wanna do new songs and sound like the young cats, but it's not really doing them any justice. You know what I mean? It's not. Here's a story. Earth, Wind, and Fire was getting ready to do a new album. And they, Jimmy Jam was producing it. And they went to Jimmy Jam and said, "Man, we want that stuff, you know, that stuff, that new stuff, that stuff they doing now, you know." And Jimmy Jam said, "Man, the stuff they doing now is y'all stuff. They can't do stuff without y'all's music."
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, but is still, which is very true. You know, our music from yesterday is still the chords and the vibe of the music today.
Yeah.
They use our samples, you know. Yeah, they updating it with these better drum machines. Did the drum machines get better over the last 20 years? Hell yeah, they did. So you know, they put new drums on top of, you know, some of these songs. And it just seems like music is still good. I'm telling you, if we could find a platform to get it to the people, like the younger folk are able to get to the people.
Yeah, but these labels ain't trying to put out the old stuff.
No, I understand that. My point is that we have to try to find another version or create a version. Hell, we're
right.
Smart. We got internet. We have online. We got all of the tools to be smart with. We just don't.
Yeah.
You know, we never were good at teaming up. You know, teaming up and creating something. I mean, you would think at this point, with all the people that, you know, like B.B. King, Richard, and all these guys that had, you know, made all this money and built all this music career for themselves and stuff, you would think there would be a company from those guys somewhere for us all still to go.
Yeah.
But there's nothing.
Right.
There's nothing.
Right.
So,
why do you think that is? Why do you think that is?
I think it's because, I don't think it's because, like you take a guy like Jay-Z or one of these guys that's running one of these places, right?
Your microphone breaking up. Are you, is there a reason why you walking around so much? Because I can't hear you.
I'm just nervous. Nervous energy.
Yeah, well, you see him on stage. You don't stand still on stage.
I can't stand still. You remember me.
You need to sit up. Man.
Where the hell I stand still at?
Damn, I hear you going in and out and in. I'm trying to catch what you're saying, brother.
Okay, sorry about that. But, I got a lot of noise coming on in the background. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Can you hear that?
Yeah, we hear something. I don't know what it is.
Okay, let me try to shut this door. Hold on. And then I'm stable. Let me try to shut this. Okay, that's got to be better, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah.
Have you just sit your ass down and start moving around, it's a lot better.
That ain't gonna happen.
I play bass, but no, I figured like guys like Jay-Z, Puffy, these guys, you know, they really run these companies. I just think they still haven't taken a meeting with any of us to be able to get that door opened, because if they knew that there was a version of a way to capitalize on what we do, I think that they would consider it. But I don't think nobody's pitching that to these guys. I look at Charlie Wilson's career, it's still going on pretty good.
Yeah.
You know, he's not really, but his people that's behind him are really pushing that genre.
Yeah.
But only him, though. Only him.
Well, see, I think what needs to happen is, and hopefully I'll be able to do it before I die, is what happened is we need to start an international black music coalition of musicians working together for one another, with one another,
yes,
to preserve our music integrity and help ourselves become successful, just like FUBU, for us, by us.
Yeah.
For us, by us. But musicians are selfish assholes, most of them.
Yeah.
All they think about is their damn self.
Yeah.
All they think about is I got more than you got. All they got is everybody pay attention to me and fuck you. That's what most musicians do. That's why we get manipulated so easily, because somebody hit somebody on the head and kick that a little bit, and they think it's all about them and they don't care about nobody else. That's the problem, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Thank God I have to play music again to make a living. Because if I had to depend on black people to keep the blues alive, forget it. That's why white people play the blues. That's why the white people play the blues and water it down, because they don't have the same ingredients that we have from our culture.
No.
Because our culture, we black. But you know, a white guy saying in our culture, he's doing a fairly decent job, but it ain't going to be the same thing. No different than if I wanted to be a country western singer, all my friends live in Texas.
They'd
be like, what the fuck you singing, man? You ain't no real country guy. At least Charlie Pride was for real country.
Yeah, he was.
But, you know, black people, man, we are our own worst enemies, man.
Totally.
Because we don't help each other like we used to do. We don't help one another like we used to do. We
no,
only
we
care
don't.
About ourselves.
Yes.
And you be feeling like, well, I better not say something because they ain't going to let me in with them if I say something. Like Tony Coleman talking right now. Because Tony Coleman don't give a fuck. I don't need you.
Right.
I'm good, man. If I died, I'd have been in 98 countries around the world.
Yeah.
I made all all kinds of fun.
Yeah.
I don't need nothing. If I can't play and have integrity and support my race, my culture, and get support from my own people, forget it, baby.
Yeah. Totally agree.
Because I'm trying to, I heard some names you said. I'm trying to approach them as Tony Coleman, like I've always done all my life. Hey, man, there's two of us. Tony Coleman going on the tour bus. Hey, who you got in there, man? Who you rolling with? Puff Daddy. That happened to me in Miami.
Yeah.
Hey, man. I'm B.B. King's drummer. Hey, come on, man. My dad created the metal thing with Danny Brown. Oh, yeah, that's cool. Yeah, man. Well,
yeah, exactly.
You need to move out of the way, man. The man coming out in a minute, man.
Yeah.
Hey, man, well, just tell the dude who I am. I'd like to meet him and talk to him. Well, you ain't gonna have that, bro.
No.
Because you hire a bunch of assholes with you.
Yeah.
Who don't give a shit about nothing but themselves.
No. Yep. That's right.
But we're not talking about it, talking about it, bro. And I hear a lot of black brothers get endorsements, help them, told them how to get endorsements. I've been inclusive with white people, black people. Hey, man, come on in. Come on, hang out with us. How you doing, dude?
Yeah.
We don't do that shit no more because everybody fucking selfish, man.
Yeah.
Got videos by video houses. Hey, you ain't shit but in one toilet. What you need nine for?
Right.
It's a bunch of bullshit, man.
Yeah,
and it's time for
totally
talking
agree.
About it.
I was trying not to say it.
You know, I just hear you say Earth, Wind, and Fire when Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis to produce them to give us y'all sound. And the man say, they already using your sound.
They using your damn sound. What do you mean? Create a sound?
Hey, man, you ain't got to do nothing but be who you are, man. Be yourself. Because to be honest with you, Earth, Wind, and Fire records don't have nothing like when Maurice White was alive, man.
No, exactly.
Yeah.
Yep.
I got the records. I can compare records. They don't have the same ingredients. You got to stay with that ingredient that man, what made that man successful.
You would think they would be somewhere near.
In my opinion.
Yeah, I agree.
Hell, I remember when go ahead. Somebody else talk.
Go ahead.
Get him started. There you go. Go ahead. Rap on, Mr. Coleman.
All I'm saying, I grew up you guys grew up in segregation when we used to be niggers. We didn't grow up being my nigga. We was niggers.
Yes.
Niggers.
Niggers, that's
you
right.
Black, you black fucking niggers. That's what we grew up to be. You better not go over there in that white man's area over there because they will kick your black ass.
Yeah.
You can't drink the same water. That's what we got in us. That's what we grew up with. So we had to protect one another. And so when we see another black brother, we'd be like, hey, man, how you doing? Got back. I'm here.
Since we got into it,
hey, and I'm not Malcolm X. I'm not Farrakhan. I'm Tony Khan, okay? I'm not Al Sharpton. I got my own mind, my brain. I ain't no Muslim, no Uslam. I'm just a Tony damn Cohen, a black man. I don't need no other black people to tell me how to be black, how to be me. I'm Tony Khan.
Exactly.
I ain't endorsing nobody. I'm endorsing what's right over what's wrong. I don't give a damn who it is, man.
Yeah.
And, you know, until we as black people, we need to get our shit together. We done forgot our... I'll be respectful to each other. This white man would sit his knee on this man and kill his ass.
Yeah.
Every black person in America today ought to be saying, man, we pissed off as a race.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We don't want to hurt nobody. We don't want to burn shit down. Nope. We just want some motherfuckers to respect us as human beings, man.
No, I think that's all we ever asked for.
Yeah.
We don't want to burn nothing, shit, burn shit up and shoot each other and shit. But the reason we shoot each other, what kills me, fucking Ice Cube was talking about, I'm going to talk to Donald Trump and this, that, and other. And Ice Cube, what you with NWA niggas with attitude?
Yeah.
All of a sudden, when you got near with money to, now you different.
That's right.
What are you talking about, man? You know how...
Uh-oh, we lost it.
Yeah, I can hear you now. No. You done blew your speaker out, bro. Can't hear you nothing. You talking loud, saying nothing. Oh, man.
No.
Can't hear nothing, Tony.
Hey, this happens on live TV, so.
Yeah.
This is the new way.
Yeah. That's it. You on there now, Tony? Can't hear nothing.
Oh, shit, I better plug you cut, in.
You cut yourself off, bro. Can't hear nothing you're saying. Nah, anyway, we just do what we do. Try to add him back on here now.
There you go.
Hey. All right, Tony, try it again. There you go.
What I was trying to say is something I did. NWA. Can y'all hear me?
Yes.
Yeah.
All those rappers, man, most of those rappers, you know how they got rich and famous?
Mm-hmm.
Talking about, I'm going to pop a cap in your ass, big, my nigga. Who the fuck you talking to? Black, some of them a bitch.
Yeah.
Are you paying attention? Yeah. You're not listening to me.
I hear you.
No, I hear you.
Yeah.
What are you doing, Waldo? What are you doing? Are you fucking with something?
What? I hear you.
I don't see you, man. What are you doing?
You don't see me. You see me, Charles?
You always be trying to perfect the buttons and shit when we'd be talking. You don't want me off. Get
your hands up, shit, man.
But he sees me. Charlie sees me.
I see you.
I said the reason these guys got millions of dollars is for promoting killing each other with drive-by shooters and all kind of shit.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
That's what they was out doing. He fired all this shit, promoting, killing each other, man.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's right.
That's how they made their money, man.
Yeah.
I shoot your shit and throw a deal, and I'm the baddest motherfucker on the block and all that kind of ignorant shit, man. They got rich doing that shit.
I don't understand it. I don't understand it at all.
That's how these guys got rich off of these poor people that don't have education and can't make a living going street hustlers and shit. And I'll fuck this bitch and fuck that bitch and my hoe and this bitch and that hoe and shit. And we all so hard to not be like that, man.
Now
they got rich acting like that. Man, I'm bleeding, bro. I'm bleeding. I'm bleeding. Play the ring, bro.
Yeah.
Yep. That's right.
And then you mad when the white man killed one of our motherfucking ass. And you've been, and people in Chicago at the park with their black babies and kids trying to have a picnic, and here come one of these black some of my bitches shooting.
Yeah, come
in,
shoot.
Shooting.
Yeah, come in. That's ridiculous.
Damn drive by. Yeah.
Man, I am so sick and tired of people not appreciating who we are as human beings that happen to be black.
Yeah.
I don't need Minister Farrakhan to tell me how to be a good black man. I'm a good man, period.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Who happened to be a black man?
Look here, I had a bullet to go this far away from my grandson's head on a drive-by. He's sitting in the house watching TV. And my daughter lives in a circle drive thing. And can't come by in an upper-class neighborhood. Comes by shooting a gun, came through the window, and death fall from my grandson's head sitting on the couch.
So how can we expect white racist police to respect us when we don't respect ourselves?
We don't respect ourselves, I know.
They don't understand it. They don't understand it. I don't know
how you gonna be Black Lives Matter when you don't give a fuck about your own life.
Yep.
See, That's the contradictory shit that's involved with us today.
Yeah.
John Lewis, Martin Luther King, they sitting up in heaven right now in the Lord, man. What the fuck we doing up here? We could have lived over fucking with trying to help these motherfuckers.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't
know,
man.
You blinging and you profiling in your new car and all this bullshit, man. Hey, man, in 1985, a friend of mine was bragging, man, I got a new Benz, man. I got a new SL450, right?
Mm-hmm.
What if what is that today? That ain't shit, right?
No.
You would have thought dude had decided to fly to moon, so he done got enough bling to buy him a SL450, selling drugs and doing all kind of dumb shit. He end up going, getting locked up. He's still in jail. But the point is, you're going to pop materialistic shit and your ego over my brother, being respectful to one another. I got more than you got. So fuck you, dude. We're on top of the world, baby. Crystal.
Yeah.
I don't get it, man. You taking my blackness and you making a joke out of it, brother.
Yeah. Ain't nothing but
Tony Coleman. Tony Coleman, happy guy, like music, love musicians. just have a great time doing it. Want to meet one of these young brothers who's on top of the world, Puff Daddy, and you got about five big motherfuckers twice my size. So I'm like, hey, back up a minute.
Yeah.
What the fuck, dude?
Yeah, that's right, man.
Yeah, and when we was coming up, it was an honor to for a guy like James Brown or Richard or any of those guys to walk in a room. These guys
they don't respect nobody.
They don't respect us like we respected the generation before us.
No.
Mm-mm.
I mean, not at all.
No.
Who promoted that, man? Who promoted that? Where did that come from?
I don't know where that came from, man. I don't know where that came from. That's
who promoted? Who made that be cool? Who made that be the thing to be?
I have no idea. It definitely was the hip hop community more than any other musical thing that was coming up as we came up. Because, like I said, we definitely respected the James Browns, the Sammy Davis Juniors, all of these guys, man. It was just like, just honored it if we could even be in a same building with these guys, let alone the same room or any of that.
Yeah.
And then we respected each other through the 80s, through the Funk Fest days with, you know, Rick James and Cameo and Roger Trotman, all these guys, man, they all respected each other. But then something happened, man, when these guys came out with what they call new music.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, the new music was our music.
Our music.
Being
that
sampled.
They put a rap to. Yeah.
But still never no love from where those samples came from. It's weird to me. It's like they made these samples up or something, man. I don't get it. You didn't make this shit up. When is somebody gonna actually, you know, besides Uncle Charlie, you know, which everybody decided we'll take him and make him everybody in the fucking world's uncle, okay? good marketing or whatever, but you know, because he sang on a couple of hip hop records, so he became the one guy.
Yeah.
But then
hey,
he
man.
Never.
Hey man, Charles. Look, he lost me when he didn't want his own brothers playing the song they recorded.
Exactly.
It's me with that. Now, I don't know what his brother did to her. I don't know if he fucked his wife or something. I don't know what happened. But hey, man, me being pissed off at my brother that made money together with me, whatever our differences was, I'm going to stop him from making a living?
Yeah.
To play the music that we make it? I got a problem with that. Maybe it's me. I guess I'm just a stupid motherfucker. I don't understand. Yeah.
That's good. That's great, man. With Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm.
I get it. I'm a dumb motherfucker, but I don't get that, man.
I don't either.
You can't play our music. I'm the voice on that music. You can't make a living. Only me. Uncle Charlie ain't nobody.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's crazy, man. It's ridiculous shit. It's just ridiculous.
Man, what happened to being able to help each other become better, man? What happened to that, man?
I don't know, man. Everybody threw it out the window.
Everybody was jealous.
You know, what happened everybody to us jealous. Looking out for one another, man?
I know.
And wanting to see each other do good.
I know,
man.
My
what
family, we were raised to look out for the next person. I was raised to look out. I can't get rid of that if I wanted to. I own this studio, this recording studio right now because I'm here looking.
So what happened?
I'm still here. My phone rang, so.
Okay, where Tony go?
Tony disappeared on us.
Coleman, come on back. Here you come.
Yep.
Yeah, you back, Tony? You hear us, Tony?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I watched that out. I watched that trial in Minneapolis on TV the other day, and I started crying. It hurt me so much, man. To see that brother explain what happened, and then he started crying. He can talk. That shit hurt me right now, bro.
Yeah.
When did we become so selfish as a black race that we only... We only come together when it's something bad happens.
That's true. That's really true.
Why we don't come together when everything's good and to make it better? All we do come together when some bad shit happens and bitch about it.
Yep. Yeah.
Now all of a sudden, you know, it's hard sometimes to be trying to say, hey, man, we got serious racism going on today like we had in the 50s and 60s,
yeah,
man.
It's bad.
It's happening right now.
No,
it's bad,
right?
Man.
No, it's
not
bad.
A joke, man. Just because some black people got college degrees and lots of money and you can buy materialistic shit where people piss on you because you black and you don't even see it because you say, oh, that's these poor-ass niggas. They ain't got nothing to do with me.
Yeah.
But when you're black ass... is out in the hot sun or in the cold trying to vote because you only got one place for all y'all to vote. And these motherfuckers, damn, they did it, man. They came out and voted.
Yeah.
And they got rid of this motherfucker. Damn. We got to do something like that. Let's make sure that they can't goddamn it do it on Sundays. Let's make sure they can't come out there and be giving each other water and shit.
Yeah.
Make them, you have to get a law. You bring them all, put some water in the hot sun that's dry, throat dry, and about to have a sunstroke, and you bring this water to vote, we're going to lock you up.
We're going to lock you up. That's the most unbelievable shit I've ever heard in my life.
We're going to lock you up. Yeah.
We're going to lock you up.
And now, my black ass supposed to be happy. Oh, I ain't worried about that. That don't affect me. And then when I talk like this, now, I'm a crazy motherfucker.
Yeah.
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 Hey, man, I can't do it. I cannot do it. I didn't play music just to be me. My music, your music, his music, it's a gift from God, gave us the talent.
Yes.
I didn't go to school to learn how to play drums.
Right.
I can't read music.
Right. Yeah.
I can do it with my feeling, man, and what I have in my soul, man.
Right.
I yeah. play music. I hear a lot of people say, hey, man, I was watching the Beatles. I hear a lot of rock players say this. White boys, rock and roll, say, I was watching the Beatles and some girl screaming, that's what I want to do. Man, I ain't give a fuck about nobody, man, except me playing them damn drums, man.
Right.
I had lots of girls talking about, I want to meet you. I got to pack my drums up first. If you can wait over there, I'll be able to meet. I gotta take care of my drum equipment right now.
Yep.
So yep. We do what we were given a gift to do, to bring the world together, yep. To be honest and open up bullshit.
Yep.
And help people have clarity about what's happening and change it. I ain't just talking this shit just to be a angry black man.
Right.
Yeah. There's a lot of wrong out there, man. I tell you, there's a lot of wrong.
We can change it, man. Singing songs ain't shit. It may not be real and change shit, man.
Yeah, well, you know, a lot of the songs that we're writing right now is about change. And as good as I know those songs are,
I am having trouble when I walk in the company because the songs are preaching change, and it's freaking, you know, it's kind of making guys feel like, eh. They really would rather me come in talking about some total bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, and, you know, we try to do some couple of fun songs, you know, so people could still be fun or whatever. But we're really trying to get the message across because won't nobody do it.
Yeah. Yeah, I got a whole CD of change songs. Think about what you're doing, you know.
Yeah.
Think about what's going on. But like you said, you know, they don't want that, baby. They want that stupid shit.
Yeah, they do.
And all of this so-called ranting that I sound like I'm doing, it's because I love people. Not because I hate nobody.
Right.
Because I love people.
You want that love. Just want that love back. Want that love back.
And I respect people. See, Waldo, that's why I say love is overrated, bro. Love, that word love is overused, overrated. The word that I want to see is respect. Respect. I ain't got to know you to respect you. I have to know nothing about you. Right. If I see another human being, I was raised to say, how you doing, sir? Good afternoon, sir. Ma'am, thank you. You're welcome. That's respect. I got to respect you before I even know you. That's the right thing to do. It's about respect, man.
Yeah.
You respect your fellow man. I love you. A lot of people say they love people. I said he loved Tina, but he beat the shit out of her. So what do I love? She said, what's love got to do with it?
Mm-hmm. You know what? I got to say, since I've been here in Germany, in this part of Germany, in Stuttgart, and especially since we got this restaurant, we have seen, and I have gotten so much respect. It's really incredible, really, really, really incredible. I'll say out of 3,000 or 4,000 people, we might have had 3 or 4 people that want to act stupid, you know. But the total amount, man, has been so nice and respectful. And I'll go back to this point, Mr. Coleman. Some of the ones, the snooty ones, the snooty people that have been to our restaurant have been blacks. You hear me?
Yeah, man. Yeah. Yeah.
They have been blacks. And it's like why? I play with them. I mess with them. I try to make them laugh. Try to make them smile. And like, you know, because here, you know, you got a lot of white guys with the African woman and stuff like that. And the guys would be cool. And the women would be like, hello. and I was like, you know, like, oh, what the fuck wrong with you? You got something stuck up your ass or something. And sometimes I call them out. I said, well, you don't know how to smile? You having a bad day? Your man didn't treat you good or something? What? You know, find out I might get a little... You know,
hey,
but
man.
You know, I've learned how to come more or less direct and not hold back a lot of stuff. But here I got to say, I really haven't needed that a lot, and I really feel sorry for the people in the States and stuff because other parts of over here also, you know. But, you know, especially in the States, man, it's so stupid. It's so disrespectful. So, I'm sorry to say this. How can so many motherfuckers believe in Donald Trump? How can that possibly be? Somebody tell me. I don't understand.
Racist. Racist. Period. Racist. Period. Here's the problem I got. What we're going through as black people, and knowing what that motherfucker is all about and how he disrespect us and hate us, and he tried to lock them black boys up in New York City and was spending money on ads trying to lock them up. They found out they were not guilty. All of the racist shit. And then when you are a white person and know what you see the fact and make excuses, they're making excuses for this motherfucker right now to kill that black man in front of everybody. If you listen to them, it's his fault. He got the knee on that because he did it. It's always some racist white people. I'm not talking about good white people, man. I got white people in my friends that I love and respect.
Yeah.
So like people, racist white people in this country, who most of them are white men, racist. They fucking hate us, man.
Yeah.
They hate black asses. And I'm talking about those people. And until white people understand that you need to be really about what you say you're about and get against those motherfuckers and tell them your days are over, man. You can't kill black people like you've been doing and then try to make excuses for it. Well, maybe the guy was a drug addict, crack, or wasn't he a thug? You know, wasn't he? Well, he was a big old black ass motherfucker. You know, he was, and we had to kill him, man. And you say, well, that. If I walk my dogs and was on the side of the street beating one of my dogs, you, like I said, white people pull on, is that nigga crazy pants? That should be, man.
Yeah,
that's right.
So for me to sit here and try to be just happy and just be quiet, like that big Fox told what's his name, just shut up and dribble, nigga.
Yeah. Yeah, I told LeBron. Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm saying, man. I embrace all humanity. All humanity. I love country, reggae, jazz, some pop, some rap. I love music. I love them places in the world. I love humanity. I love everybody. But when a motherfucker is fucking with me and I'm pissed off about it, white friend, support me, white friend?
Mm-hmm.
Fuck you, man.
Everybody has the right to decide who they want.
No, everybody don't have the right to like racist motherfuckers.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Mm-hmm.
That's where I say, hey, man, just don't fuck me. Move on. I don't need you in my life because you don't give a fuck about me because I care about humanity, man. And, you know, we're going backwards over here in America. We're going backwards, bro. Can't be musicians quiet and just happy to got a gig, man. I don't need no fucking gig, bro.
Yeah.
How you gonna
and the other bad part on it, the other bad part is that surprisingly, it's so many black people like the white people.
They hate themselves. It ain't that they like the white people. They hate themselves.
No, I'm talking about the black people that hate us. They hate. I'm going to say this. The most times I've ever got fucked was by a black person.
Waldo, I refuse to blame the white man for me hating a black man.
No, I ain't blaming nobody. I'm just saying, okay. Just like you said earlier, we hurting ourselves.
But like I said, the reason I'm hurting you is because I don't give a fuck about me. That's what I'm trying to say, right, man.
Yeah.
Myself. How you expect me to care about you?
Right.
Yeah.
I love me, man. I love me.
Right.
Another brother, another person. Well, like I said, we walk through the airport. We back. I don't even know you and what we do.
Yeah.
We do the chin, man.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
These young black people today, they don't know the chin.
chin?
No, they don't fuck the chin. They not doing no chin.
That motherfucker had a Gibson guitar bag, a musician, young cat, had a Gibson. I knew it was like a Les Paul or something from the case. I knew it was Les Paul. I saw it was in Chicago. I was going east, he going west. I did him like that. And they're looking like, this motherfucker gay or what? He want me or something?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So,
can't even speak to you no more.
I went to see something. Dude was coming to Nashville from Chicago. I said, hey, man. Dude looked at me like, this motherfucker been flirting with me. I guess that way, talk something. I say, hey, man, you're a musician, right? Yeah. You know who B.B. King is? Yeah. Oh, yeah, B.B. King. I'm his drummer. Oh, he's his drummer? Now, see, when I said that, now all of a sudden he changed his motherfucking attitude.
Yeah.
He might be my friend and do something.
Right.
Yep. He said that same fucking attitude if I say I play with Turtle Man Johnson or some motherfucker.
Right.
But we so into ourselves, man. We don't give a shit about our race. And we let people run over us and say, well, I ain't got nothing to do with that. I'm good. So, you know, I ain't, you know. Sad, man. It's sad, man.
Yep.
We got to figure it out, man.
That's why I was on that stage with Jamie Johnson. I love country music and shit. And when that boy, when that motherfucker pulled that Confederate flag out, and he was waving it at me, smiling and shit, I said, fuck you, fuck that flag. I'm Jimmy Johnson stage. And they were like, this nigga's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't give a fuck about nobody. All I said was, you're not going to disrespect me, none of y'all. I respect all you. All you white motherfuckers out there, artists, I respect you. You going to get a Confederate flag and wave at my black ass?
Yeah.
And smile?
Yeah. Yeah.
You man, Jamie Johnson. I saw some of the guys in that band stuff. They were looking at each other like, I know he getting rid of this nigga here. Oh, Jamie Johnson smiled me and wink and give me the flag, and he was with me. So I'm simply saying, man, we are intelligent white musicians and black musicians. We've always been able to cut together and play music together, just like the black and white keys, man. But you know what? I want to hear you so-called white friends of mine speak out against this shit going on in Georgia.
Yeah.
No, yeah. Yeah, that's some crazy shit, bro. That's some real crazy shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. But look here, y'all.
That's what's happening.
Let's take a little 5 minute thing right here, and let me get to this, and we'll be right back. We'll be right back.
Five albums, one legendary record label. The name of the band: OZone. Motown initially used OZone as backing musicians for artists, including Billy Preston, Syreeta, and Tina Marie, before allowing them to record the first of 5 albums in 1980. Rick James and Tina Marie used them extensively on their projects, including Behind the Groove, Square Biz, I Need Your Lovin', Portuguese Love, and Fire and Desire. Motown released their first album, Walk On. A song from that album appeared on the soundtrack for the movie, It's My Turn, an instrumental track that showcased the band's musical prowess. They performed the song on the television show, The Midnight Special, hosted by Wolfman Jack. The name of the song was Walk On, and the band received their first taste of chart success. The subsequent albums, Jump On It, Send It, Lil Susie, and Glasses yielded more radio hits. Songs like Lil Susie, Strut My Thang, and Gigolette proved that this band was here to stay.
Strut! Are y'all ready to strut? Say it! Let me hear you say it! I want all the ladies to sing it! Fellas, strut! We'll see y'all later. Come on, let me hear you. Everybody, everybody, everything said OZone. 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 Now scream! Good night, y'all.
Enough land for graves. You ain't the judge, your name ain't dread. What the hell is going through your head? You can't serve out of effect. You don't need to punish them yet.
You ain't the judge, your name ain't dread. What the hell is going through your head? You can't serve out of effect. You don't need to punish them yet. You ain't the judge, your name ain't dread. What the hell is going through your head? Serve out of appetite. You don't need to punish him yet.
Come on.
your name ain't dead. What the hell is going through your head? You here to serve, I'm an epithet. You don't need to punish him yet. You ain't the judge, your name ain't dead. What the hell is going through your head? You here to serve, I'm an epithet. You don't need to punish him yet.
Judgment time.
Yeah, man. Yeah, Charlie.
I love those clips.
One of my things. I had to throw it in there.
Now that's what we need more of. It's the damn police and the cats having dance offs. You know.
Yeah, yeah.
You got to break off into a dance off. You know what I mean? Pull out some shit. And say, wait a minute. You got only one thing is gonna keep you from going to jail tonight. That's for you to outdance me right now. Just play on the intercom of the police car and it's on.
It's on, boy. I tell you, it is on, man. Yeah, I seen your boy in the house. Where'd he go?
Who? Trotter?
Right, yeah.
Okay, yeah, there you go. Because that's why I kept going off. I was trying to send him the link.
Well, he was on here twice and then he's off.
Oh, okay. Well, I all right. Then I send him the link.
Yeah, hit him again real quick there.
All right. Hold on.
Here he is.
All right, okay.
He's here, Charlie.
Cool.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got none other than Sir Nose the Border Funk.
What's happening?
What's going on, Sir Nose the Border Funk?
How you feeling?
I don't want to dance. No.
Can't get me to do it. Can't get me.
Yeah. From Parliament Funkadelic, George Clinton.
How you doing?
Now with OZone.
So, Waldo, what's up? Good. How you feeling? How's everything going?
Hey, man, trying to make a dollar.
Out of 17 cents.
Oh. You got 17 cents. You're a rich man. You got 17 cents.
That's right. Out of 17 cents. You know.
Yeah, shoot, you got some money. You got 17 cents. Yeah. Yeah, man. Things going pretty good, man. What's going on with y'all?
Oh, man, we're doing great, man. I'm down here in Las Vegas right now. And we got some great things jumping off with the OZone Gold radio station and everything that we're putting in the front. And we got some great things. I'm sure Charles probably went over it with you a little bit, but we got Punch TV that's really getting ready. We get ready to do the 40-year anniversary of OZone itself. And it's everything's just going, man. It's just pulling in. We're going to be doing a big pay-per-view show on that. So we're doing a lot of the editing, getting that stuff out the way and getting things in order to be able to bring it to the people.
It's been 40 years, Charles.
Yep. Oh, so y'all didn't discuss that part, huh?
No.
Yeah. We just New Year's first. We just filmed the full pay-per-view show and everything else over there at Punch in California. And right now we're dealing the editing and getting all that stuff together now. So it'll be coming at you very soon, very shortly.
I didn't realize that, Waldo, until I was at the show that we were filming and the guy asked me a question and I said, well, damn, this is our 40th anniversary. Had no clue. Because 79.
We 79.
Signed. 79 we signed. And here we are. 21. Yeah.
There you go. See?
And it all started in 1976.
Yeah, it started in 76. That's right. With the endeavors.
And all that information will be there. All that information is there.
All that stuff. You didn't come back. When did you come back to Nashville, Charles? For me and Jerry, came.
We all came back together.
Were we together?
Yeah, we all came back together thinking we was going to come back and make more money.
See, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. See, I'm bringing back memories for you guys.
But we, me and Jerry was in the Ryder truck.
Yeah.
Was you in the truck?
No, I wasn't in the truck.
How did you get back?
I don't know. I think we drove. We all drove.
We might have left back before y'all or something.
Well, I might have flew back. I could fly free, so I don't.
Yeah, daddy had your ass. See, me and Charles, daddy, real good friend.
Yeah, okay.
The bartender at the airport.
Yeah, bartender at the airport, big time.
Yeah. Wow. Every time I come in, he hooked me up. Yeah. He hooked me up. Yeah, man. But wow, it's been that long.
There he is right there. Airport bartender can tell a few of his own.
Whoa,
wow.
He got you. He got you right there.
Wow.
How crazy is that?
Wow.
Yep, he talks about his Bloody Mary and all of that.
Well, that's really going back, man.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going back to 476.
Yeah, it actually was, yes.
Yeah, well, we just had to make an adjustment on one of the promotional pieces that is going out for the pay-per-view, because they had the group at in the 70s, and Charles told them no, it was the 80s.
So we
just had to make that adjustment today, which I just did. While y'all on the phones doing all these beautiful interviews and lounging, you know, somebody got to work.
Yeah, man, I'll be the interview here. We've been in here sweating, talking about white this, black that,
once we got to talking about, you know, people, that shit changed. We forgot all about we was musicians.
We don't want to get into that part, because Charles and I had I was checking into Ontario because we had a session that we was getting ready to do the next dawn. And it's one of the things where Charles and I was sitting in the lobby and we was checking in almost what it was about like 4+ years back, Charles.
Trump was running.
And Trump was running for president. And this brother came up on us and was talking about, oh, yes, getting ready to be like it's going to be, and started saying all these negative things about how, you know, we can get out as men and start playing in the streets and players and get our hustle on. And we was like, oh, no, man.
Yeah.
We was like, you do not want that to happen, because, and then we started telling him all the negative and all the things that was going on with if he gets in there and what this administration was going to be doing. And sure enough, the brother was sitting there, and as we sit there and told him, and sure enough, as he was elected, everything that we were saying from the phantom of the riots and everything else that's going down, and everything that was going down in his administration with them lying and everything else, man, was at the top of the list. We wrote, for the last 4 years, we've been putting together the new album and locking in the new album, and pretty much it tells the whole story. Everything that's going on right now with Stand Up For Your Rights and a lot of the songs that we have, Think Before You Talk, and a lot of the songs that we have on this new album that we're doing, it's like a landscaping of everything that's been going down and everything that was happening. It's really incredible. It's really incredible.
That's why I had mentioned how we had songs written where, you know, it's really touching on where the world is right now.
Yes.
And I mentioned how, you know, we go in, try to have meetings in these companies, and these guys, because we have a message as opposed to just talking about some pussy or some shit.
Right. And you know, we fighting them all the way. So we're taking our own route right now.
Right. And that's what we're doing. That's what, well, that's why we like y'all said, we taking our own route and connected with Heaven Gilmore and some strong people out of Miami, Florida. And yeah. Basically going ahead and locking in. We launched the Ozone Gold Radio Show, which is on ozonegoldradio.com. You can pull
which I can't get over here.
A lot of our German friends, a lot of our friends has basically been sending us and trying to, you know, figure out how we can stream the station over there. So we're working with it with our tech people right now to be able to, you know, see how we can actually open up that stream for you guys over there.
Right.
So
well,
you know,
it's more than tech. It's a lot of stuff Germany just don't allow. You know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Some videos you can't even see over here. You know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But most of my stuff is hooked up like I'm in the U.S.
Right. There you go.
But for whatever reason, your radio show won't do that. Because, see, I had a radio show on 365 a few years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I got concerned because I really wasn't getting the information that I needed about the royalty fees for the music and stuff.
Right, right.
And then, you know, something happening, you know, so I just finally just kind of dropped.
Well, you know, we...
Because
basically, we have built our own servers. So we're having our servers built. And right now, as we're locking in with 365, they're pretty much just holding some of the ground of our broadcasting right now until our servers are built. Then when our servers are built, then we are taking on and we're going to be totally, you know, totally live on our own.
Okay. Rodney, this is B.B. King's drummer. Tony T.C. Coleman.
Wait a minute.
Meet
I know
Sir, sir knows the border funk.
I know Tony T.C. Coleman. I know Tony T.C. Coleman. What's happening?
Oh, Lord, you in trouble now.
Yeah, wait a minute. He did some. Were you with B.B. when we brought him up to Chicago, wasn't you? When we did the African Fest. Tony, what's up, man? I ain't seen you in that. Charles Cooper and Leslie and all of us and Patrick Woodrow up in Chicago. Yeah, when we did all the stuff for the Lollapalooza and stuff. How you doing?
I'm good, man. You know, Waldo let me out every now and again, and he takes the chain off me. He takes the chain off me, and he let me loose.
It ain't easy. It ain't easy.
How you doing, man?
Oh, man, doing great, man. Sitting up here working with Mr. Glenn and locking in to the lead singing for Ozone right now and, you know, really pulling some stuff together. And, you know, Steady got the concert and a series network that we're pulling together and locking all in. So we're getting ready to do a lot of great things, man.
Great, brother. Great, man. It's so good to hear that, man.
Yeah. Yeah. I just talked to Bobby Rush the other day. Bobby Rush and all of them, and he's here because I'm getting ready to open up a blues network for the radio station as well as with the concert division.
What is blues?
Huh?
What is blues?
We're going to open up the blues network for the radio station.
What is blues?
What he is said, blues that fires music?
He ain't played in so long. You know what blues
is. Forgot.
Waldo, you have got how to be black since you live in Germany now. You know, you really too uppity for me sometimes.
Hey, got to be. Don't hate a player.
You know, I can say one thing, Tony. I was jealous of y'all. One of the times we was overseas when we was doing that tour over there, right? Well, on our way back, BB was on the same plane with us, and Richard was so old school, man. He didn't believe in computers or direct deposit or none of that. I mean, he was still writing us checks, you know, writing all over the check and all of that. And BB was on the plane, had his laptop, and he was taking care of all of y'all salaries. All y'all shit was all direct deposit and all of that. And I'm like, damn, they were the real business. And we were this damn nigga shit. What?
People don't know. BB was a computer nerd. BB goes to the computer shop in Vegas. BB was a pilot. People don't know that. BB flew himself for years.
Wow.
Wow.
Wow. I didn't know that. I didn't know that.
BB could tell you anything about software and all of that stuff, man. He was like a computer nerd guy, man.
Wow. Wow.
Yep, I definitely remember that, man. I was like, I remember how amazed I was to see him. And I mean, he was on his laptop the whole time. So kind of pissed him a little bit. So, hey, so, you know, I see you on your laptop and stuff. He's like, yeah, I have to take care of the payroll. Get everybody's money and stuff straight. And then I remember talking to one of you guys, man. He was like, y'all was like, yeah, we get benefits and we get so and so.
BB was taking care of his
BB took care of us. We were retained. We got paid half salary whether we worked or not.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Because I remember
BB, we had done that with BB.
Well, Tony, you ain't got to try to piss everybody off, okay?
Hey, I remember when they came up in Chicago, man, and we was on the same show and was doing the whole thing. It was and I was acting, you know, dealing with the, you know, with the actual promoters and everyone. And BB itself. Because again, BB knew my dad and, you know, and a lot of my mom and them, because he was Red Saunders, Charles Cooper. Remember Charles Cooper? Charles Cooper.
I do.
And Ambassador Webb and Rick and all of them was there. And they was sitting up there and we, you know, had a big thing where we was going to go meet BB at the airport. Well, we all went out. BB was supposed to fly into Midway. I mean, he was supposed to fly into O'Hara, and he flew into Midway on a private charter. And next thing I know, the bill came over, and they didn't know nothing about it. They had his tickets and everything else. He come in on his own private charter. We said, "What the? What the hell?" And ended up picking it up, but it was all good.
You know, the coolest thing, I don't know if all of this been or not with James Brown, but y'all know where the Monterey Jazz Blues Festival is, Monterey?
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh.
And you know, if you look across the way over there to your right, at an angle, you can see the airport over there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The airport is over there on the stage on the right. You can see it out in the back a little bit. Mr. Brown was coming in from L.A. Danny Ray, they had that shit timed. He said, the world greatest soul in the world. The king of soul himself, Mr. James Brown. Look up there. There he go. And he was landing in the plane. Man, that's the cool shit I'm talking about.
Wow. Wow.
While he was landing, and you could see the lights over there, the police escort went over there and grabbed him. He was still, the band was batting.
Wow. They know how to do Showtime on you, boy.
Yeah.
That was the coolest shit the introduction I saw. The man
that
playing,
was cool.
Got the car. All they want to say is that he looked at himself in the mirror a little bit, and then they was hitting that shit. Oh,
Yeah, see? That's fireworks right there.
You got damn right, he is.
Boy, that was a bad motherfucker.
Yeah, we're gonna have to steal that, Charles.
That's
hey, but Tony, before we go on there, Father, I just want to give you some of this here.
You what?
What the hell?
I just want to give you some of this here.
What the hell?
What the hell you got?
What the hell what you got?
Well, yeah, come closer. Let me see. Oh, you have a Rodney.
Yeah.
If you open up the dictionary, they don't have it. But if you open the Tony Coleman dictionary.
Yeah.
My dictionary. And it's got a word in there called asshole. It's a picture of a right there. See, he knows to lose weight. He knows my favorite food is ice cream. Whatever flavor, ever. He knows my favorite food is ice cream. I cannot eat ice cream. I'm on a diet. I'm trying to get healthy. I'm trying to be cute like him. And his asshole eating ice cream in front of me.
See, look at that. Look at that.
What happened?
Look at that.
Oh,
see?
I'm sorry.
He over there teasing.
Look at him. You know he's wrong for that. And y'all know I like that ice cream when it's just about melting, you know, it's kind of soupy, you know, and that's what he did.
He over there doing you wrong.
I don't know why I would do that to me, man.
But I want to know what is the climate over in Germany right now? Is it hot, cold? What's going on?
Yeah, well, the past couple of days has been like summer, and now the temperature's going down, and down, and Wednesday is supposed to snow again.
Oh, man.
Well, see, y'all getting all that snow. I'm just going to reflect. Y'all see that pyramid back there?
You see this?
Y'all see that pyramid in back of me right there?
Yeah.
You see this? You see this here? Do you see this right here?
I just want to reflect and let y'all know.
this is the Lincoln Memorial.
With T, I was just wanting him to know that he eating that ice cream. I couldn't even eat that ice cream unless I was someplace chill, because I'm sitting here in Las Vegas, the sun is shining, the beautiful. They done reopened up everything and got it going on. And I'm in my suite, just kicked back, sitting over here talking to you guys and letting y'all know how much love I got for you.
I love you, man. Hey, man.
Yeah, look at my city.
This is what I'm saying. You know, they all out. He eating ice cream, and all out there in the cold. I got beautiful women out here in Las Vegas. I would turn the camera around, but I don't want to get nobody in trouble.
Go ahead, get them in trouble. Come on, baby, I'm in. Come on.
Hey, Waldo.
Yeah.
Waldo Weathers.
Yes, sir.
You know, you know I'm gonna be back with doing this.
Huh?
You know I'm gonna pay you back for what you're doing, eating that ice cream in front of me like that. That's the second time you did that. This is the second time. You don't get three times.
You don't know how much you're paying me back. You know why? Because you're going to Nashville where I ain't thought about nothing but Mary's and Ed's fish.
Yeah.
And all that. But Tony, I want to tell you this. My lady just told me, she said, you know, on the videos on Facebook, you know, they have the words underlying what we're saying and everything, you know, the teleprompter thing. And she said, Every time you say MMF, they got dot, 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 dot. And she says to count, it's probably been about 150 times that you use the word MF and they dot, 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 dot. That's oh, pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, well, it's up to you to explain to her that, you know, it's a black thing and that motherfucker been around from the beginning of a black folk in America. The motherfucker. It's not motherfucker, it's motherfucker. It's like Bernie Mac.
It's a noun.
To
Bernie Mac broke it down to you.
Bernie Mac explained it. So send her to Bernie Mac saying what motherfucker means.
Yeah. Bernie Mac broke it down to everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah. But break it down to the teleprompter.
Well, see, motherfucker is a person, place, or thing. Is what Bernie was trying to tell you.
It's a thing. So
it's a person, place, or thing.
I'm gonna give a quick example of what my black ass is gonna explain about you and motherfucker. Waldo, you know motherfucker, but you had motherfucker in front of motherfucking face. Cause you know that motherfucking ice cream more than you could ever motherfucking know. And you know I'm trying to lose motherfucking weight. Your motherfucking ass is up making motherfucking irritated doing that motherfucking shit because you know you're no good motherfucker for doing it.
But see, I forgot. You know, I apologize.
That's why I had to sit up there and show him that Charles and I, we in the heat. We ain't back there eating no ice cream. We gotta worry about being able to put this tanning lotion on to keep us cool. Sure, he over there trying to jack you with some ice cream.
And yes, well, black people do put on sunscreen. We do burn.
see, all three of y'all on the West Coast, see?
Hey.
So that's absolutely no fair. See, I'm already pissed off.
Well, it wasn't no fair
Charles.
For you to be talking about eating
Wait a minute. I'm already pissed off at Charles anyway for being right there at the back door of Roscoe's. You don't know how many times Roscoe has come out of my mouth from chicken and waffles. And then you out there in Vegas where they got, I remember you go get a breakfast for like $5 and you got so much on the plate you can feed the poor.
That's right. And still doing it.
Yep, you can definitely get the $5 steak breakfast.
So all y'all just feel me. All y'all just feel me. And those fabulous words that Dana Ray used to say, I fuck you.
Wait a minute. See, you had a perfect opportunity to use, you know, y'all can feel in the perfect form to say, all you motherfuckers can kiss my ass.
Well, that was the next line.
And that's for all the Facebook listeners. Okay.
If I don't plug my phone in, I'm going to be messed up here.
Oh, y'all.
That's for all the Facebook listeners.
That's something.
Damn, Charles on the move again, Waldo. He on the move.
I did good. I sat for about 40 minutes.
Man, Charles always been on the move. Okay, I remember when I first got Charles in my group. Went out to L.A. And this motherfucker Uh-oh. Every day, every damn day, he wouldn't be playing his bass. He'd be outside like a little kid beating his thumbs on cement. Just as hard as he could, just beating his damn thumbs on a cement. What the fuck are you doing? I mean, should be bleeding and stuff, man. It's gonna be. I remember that like it was yesterday. You know, cat trying to get his, you know, get his blister on his thumb. So when he'd be slapping that bass, yeah, he ought to be able to slap a bass and knock a hole in it.
Right.
Yeah. There you go. So you in Nashville,
Waldo? I didn't remember that myself.
Yeah, Charles is from Nashville.
Charles, are you in Nashville?
I'm from Nashville.
No, he ain't in Nashville now.
No, I'm not in Nashville now.
He lives in California.
I thought you was in Nashville. I'll be there Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, even Thursday.
Yeah, I'm supposed to go in a few weeks, but I don't know yet. I'm trying to avoid it.
You talking about Alabama?
Yeah.
Rodney, how long you live in Las Vegas, man?
Well, I've been in Las Vegas for the last 4 years.
Oh, you live in Vegas?
Yeah. Well, I'm living between Vegas and California. I go back and forth.
All right, well, fuck you too. Anyway.
I go back and forth. You know, when Charles need me in Ontario, I get up in Ontario and then I stay up there and I'll stay, you know, 2 or 3 weeks. And when I'm through, I'll come on back here, stay 2 or 3 weeks. So I go back, but it all depends on what, you know, what the business looks like.
Well, originally Charles wouldn't let me come back to California with Ozone, see. He told me I couldn't go. I had to stay there and, you know, do something else. See, he wouldn't let me come.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. See, look at it. I see him getting away with that one, T.
Mm-hmm.
I can see. And see,
I raised him up from a pup, and
definitely raised before.
And then he become a big dog, and just kick me out on the front porch. No, I take that lie back. I had the opportunity to go, but.
Yeah, because I know he was sitting up there. He was calling a lot of. He was trying to get a lot of everybody to come on back when I came into the fold. Because yeah. I've been in. I came. He called me up. Matter of fact, it was Buns Lectors that's over there in Germany right now. Called me up and was telling me, you know, that Charles was looking for a front man for Ozone, and I was in Atlanta at the time.
Yeah,
called me up. And we got on the phone, and seeing Charles and I did a performance a while back at BB King's in Universal over there, Universal City Walk.
Yeah,
when the BB King's was over there, and you know, I was, you know, doing my Cernos and doing the whole situation, my Parliament thing there, and Charles and them was on the show, and we ended up closing the show that night with him and his boys and my boys. We all just got together and rocked that place out.
Yeah.
And the vibe was just so infectious, man. It was just so cool that it was like, it was like, man, we got to do this again. Or, you know, and it ended up where, you know, he called me up and I said, hell yeah. He told him to send me the song list, and I was out in Ontario, what it was a month later, and been with him ever since.
That's cool.
Yeah,
that's cool. I done been over here for 13 years now.
Oh wow!
And man, I just about get back over there, boy.
Well, you might as well go on and hook up a big show.
It's been 13 years, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, when it comes back, when things come back, you know, I got some hookups where I can do some.
Yeah, hook up the show, and then we're going to put you in one of the info cases and bring your ass back home.
Yeah,
that's how we going to do that.
No,
hey, man.
Don't think I won't come.
Hey, but anyway. Waldo.
Yeah, you need,
Mr. Waldo, you know I'm the one that helped you leave town to get over there. You remember that?
No, but I'm sure you'll tell me.
Hello? Are you still there?
What you do, Mr. Coleman?
Mr. Weathers came to me, he said, man, I can leave Nashville, man. I can't take it no more. I'm going overseas, man. I got to go. He's crying, man. He's crying to me like a little four-year-old baby, man. I told him, I got a handkerchief. I said, man, blow your nose, but here you go.
How you liking it?
Blow your nose.
How you liking it over there? I know they treat me like losing COVID over there. You got your
teeth,
boy. You ain't
changed. Go, man. Waldo, I give you my blessing, son. I bless you. Go. Be on your way. God be with you.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you.
He an asshole then like he is right now.
See, there you go, Tony. He raising that old malt glass again.
See, asshole like that when I help him get over there.
Hey Charles, have you let him hear any of the new music?
Waldo's got something. Waldo, did you get what I sent you?
Yeah.
So how you liking it? How you like it over there, man? How you feeling with that?
The new songs?
Yeah.
What I would like to hear for you all is to get back in the gate with something a little bit more commercial. And then when you go through that gate, then jump back off into that other thing. But I'm hoping, see y'all young enough, you know, I'm 71, you know, I done been in the gate, out of the gate, and in the field. But I'm hoping for y'all to do something more commercial.
What do you consider more commercial?
Something like, you know, I'm going to say Bruno Mars, because he's one of my favorites.
Then you need to listen again, because you're missing it. You need to listen again. Maybe he
didn't send me that one.
I know what he sent you. You need to listen again because you're missing it.
Funk generation ain't that shit, man. What?
Yeah, you need to listen again because you're missing it.
What?
Because I just got off the phone with Chris Brown and these guys, because again, they trying to come over and trying to get me to do some stuff with them right now. And I just got off the call, and also Anderson .Paak. Anderson .Paak was trying to get me to do stuff with him a while back, and I sent him three or four songs before you even hearing the stuff that you hearing with Bruno and Anderson. Me and Anderson .Paak has been partners, and I've sent him his first groove that I can send you. The actual track he sampled from my catalog. So you need to already, again, see, you guys be missing it, because again, you're saying like Bruno Mars, and those guys are sampling, and those guys are repping our sound.
I don't even know why you would even say that. You didn't
shut up,
man.
Shut the fuck up.
You know I was going to get him, what? Tony. You know I was going to get him.
Now, what I'm saying, I understand the ripoff. I understand the ripoff. Only thing I'm saying, is to go back to that. Go back to that and get back in that door. And
we already in the door. This is what I'm saying. We never left where we were in the beginning. So the bottom line is everything from Bruno, from Ice-T, Jay-Z, and any of those guys never had anything in the first place. They had to sample and then put whatever little flavor that they thought that they were spitting on top of that. So musically, you know, for you to tell us to go back to that is incorrect because we are that. And musically, go ahead, TC. Get him, TC. Go ahead. I see you shaking your head.
What you need to do is you need to keep doing what you already know because we're with the roots. What you need to do is get your ass up and get some cats like us and say, hey, man, let's show these roots.
I would do that if I could find a drummer.
No. Yeah, you can do that, but we already do it.
Yeah, anyway. We are the roots. You gotta ask the roots to teach the roots. Gotta be the root.
Yeah, I know exactly.
Thank you, TC.
Waldo, you're the reason why I'm fucking still sitting here, fucking trying to pretend that my music is fucked up because you want us to sound like a motherfucker that sounds like us. That sounds crazy.
That's copying us.
You want a motherfucker, Charles. You want a motherfucker to sound.
What'd you say, TC?
He wants you to talk to a motherfucker trying to sound like us.
There you go.
Sounds crazy. I'm going to be breaking up somewhere.
I guarantee you right now, if you Whole Foods is a real food store. You know why? Because they go to farming areas and local farmers where the fruit isn't processed and painted spray and put all kind of bullshit in the food to grow the natural way. And guess what? People spend more money for the natural shit.
That's right.
There you go.
What's real. They don't want to go fake imitation artificial shit.
Right.
So we got with the real heart and the real soul and the real roots back. And people will gravitate toward the real shit because we still vital, we still strong, we'll knock a motherfucker out.
Exactly. We still fail to realize that Bruno's only half dipping into the funk. He ain't nowhere near in the funk because
he can't get to it.
You think he's doing something different. Because he's actually doing a bullshit hip hop version of the funk. Okay? And so it's appearing that he's doing some new shit, but he's actually doing a hip hop version of the real shit.
You just need to take a piece of the modern day technology to enhance our shit that they use. Because it was a bunch of artificial steroids.
You don't know a damn thing about technology. Just sit up in that car and shut the fuck up.
See? That's what the problem is. Y'all always say we don't know. And that man that's sitting over there on the right side of that screen at the top next to you, Charles Glenn, ain't nothing but state-of-the-art technology inside of his studio.
I know what Charles Glenn got.
Well, this is what I'm saying.
I'm talking about this other gray-haired motherfucker.
But he's got
here.
The knowledge base. Yeah. He's got the knowledge base.
He
knows.
He ain't got no knowledge. He
knows
where the
real deal
about, come
from.
He don't know nothing.
TC
but
know where the real
potatoes.
Shit come from.
He don't know nothing. He don't know nothing. He don't know nothing but steak and potatoes. And I got the ice cream. He don't know nothing.
You know,
like
TC know?
I like Brown said, he don't know nothing, son.
Hold on, TC. Do I have to go back out and show him the pyramid and the sun? Do I have to go back out and show
TC. Him the sun? Rodney, you know it, Mac, that know. But you keep this shit up, we ain't going to.
You know what, TC, Waldo? I'm not to waste my goddamn breath trying to talk to your dumb ass. I know that.
No, you didn't. With your boxcar Willie ass. See, even
shit like that, what you said right there. See, them young motherfuckers, you understand what we doing when we be listening to each other. See, they wouldn't even know what the fuck he's talking about. Man, you can't know where you're going until you know where you're coming from, but some of us have no idea where you're coming from.
Wait a minute. Charles.
Yes.
I take it that you the youngest one in the group here.
Yes, that's
do you know exactly. do you know who Boxcar is?
Do I know who is?
Boxcar.
Is that a group or something?
See, show you how stupid he is. Yeah, I know. I love trains, right? I love trains. I've always loved trains since I was a little kid. I love trains. Now, Boxcar Willie, I love trains, and I got a gig working with Union Pacific and stuff, being around them damn trains. I love that shit. Boxcar Willie is a fucking hobo that was running, jumping on the boxcar. Motherfucker, I'm Casey Jones, you dumb motherfucker.
I love it.
Fucking jumping the train, you dumb motherfucker. He's gonna be jumping on the train.
Ooh, Lord. Boy. I'll tell you what.
I'm the train engineer, my man. I control the shit. I'm the motherfucking motor that make that shit run. I'm the motherfucker in the front that's spearheading the shit.
Now, you can just go on and take your little tinker to our train and go ahead with your ass. Anyway, hey, I'm going to try to do this. I don't know if it's going to work or not. But hold on a minute, guys. Hold on just one moment. Hold on. Let me see if it's going to work. I don't know if it is or not. Let me see. Can you hear it?
No.
No, I don't hear nothing.
I don't hear nothing.
You don't hear it?
No.
What you
bet Bruno, I bet Bruno's song will play though.
What the hell? What the hell are you trying to do? Charles, play my music for me. Play my daddy's records.
I couldn't load this some of my picture.
Hey, man, leave it alone.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. You get ready to hear about it even more than you can play it anyway.
It doesn't matter exactly.
You know, so don't even worry about it. You know what? No,
I was gonna play it for Boxcar down here. No, I like it.
Listen to me, then. This man just asked for a handout from a Rudy Poop motherfucker that's got a lot of money that don't know shit. Man, you got more soul in your little finger, and you used to. You got more soul in your little finger than they got in their whole body, bro.
Yeah,
you come from the genius. Hey man, if you play with Ray Charles, James Brown, B.B. King, Little Richard, all these motherfuckers we know I play with, if you grew up listening to Sam and Dave, I'm a Soul Man, and not the idea that the Blues Brothers are Sam and Dave, if you know what we know about this shit, you ought to be ashamed of yourself even saying you like that motherfucking Bruno bullshit.
That's right.
Power.
Why the, did,
preach, brother. Preach.
Did I say I liked anything?
You told us you to go back and you told us to go back. Yeah, you told us to go back. See, you about to get, like you about to get jumped on.
I didn't say I like it. It's me. You to be a West Coast motherfucker.
Now, so now you want to do a West Coast Germany rivalry, right? Yay! You know what? See? Now you want to turn it. Now you want to try to do a Suge Knight on us.
Oh, Suge Knight!
Hey, Rodney.
Oh boy!
Yeah.
It's told Charles, this man that got over there in Europe and forgot his soul, man.
Yeah, yep. Totally.
Damn sure him.
You sound like sure. Every time I get on the phone with somebody, and that's without hearing any music.
Yeah, damn sure yeah.
This man here was the creator of funk.
I know. Yep.
This man said, freeze your knees. He want to fuck with Bruno Mars.
And you want to fuck with Bruno. Hey, tell Bruno Mars to do this.
What you want to do?
Be careful that motherfucker sample it, goddamn it.
That's not, and that's exactly what he'll do. Go sample it. Because yep. That's what he's been doing. Go sample it.
Yeah.
That's what they've been doing. Tear the roof off the sucker. Tear the roof off the motherfucker. Tear the roof off the sucker. They're going to sample it.
If Bruno Mars stays with me, I make that motherfucker say time out, man. I can't sing shows and shit. I can't do this shit, man. Y'all got too much energy, man. We gotta put that shit back on the track, please, man. This motherfucker drive me off the stage with this shit. I'm sweating, man. God damn. These motherfuckers on stage worried about how two things look.
TC,
BB King, Little Richard, that's it.
TC, to give you a prayer example of what you're talking about, we was up in San Bernardino playing with the Daz Band and just a whole bunch of other artists. And all these suckers was up there tracking.
Yeah.
They were tracking their ass off.
Yeah.
Right? We came up on stage and was dropping that live funk on them. Charles was thumping. Derek Organ was kicking and slapping. Rodney Thomas on the key. We was just killing them.
Yeah.
And all I was hollering through the whole show was, this is what we do. This is the live music. This is what we do. This ain't no tracking shit. This is live. Listen to this. I'm break Charles and them down. Bring them back up. Them, they couldn't even do nothing. We stomped so much ass. We put so much King Kong stomp in their ass. We funked them all the way to the window. At the end of the show, they was just screaming and hollering.
Yeah.
Well, my God, you black people are just sound so violent. You sound so violent. I would be afraid to come to your show. I don't know what I would do.
Get
you would do
up.
It all.
You know why they ain't
got. First of all, the whole audience was white, Hispanic, and Asian.
Yep.
You can count the black people
yep.
on maybe 10 toes up and 10 toes down.
Yep. Matter of fact, if it wasn't for the talent, there wouldn't have been no black people there.
There you go.
You know that's what I said earlier.
You know
what I said earlier. Wait, that's what I said earlier that we don't support each other as a people. We don't support each other as a people, and
well,
I don't you know, really understand.
Well, let me say this. I would rather play for the people that I play for, because if I play for your ass, I got you sitting there talking about I need to sound like fucking Bruno.
There you go.
That shit.
Hey, man.
That's why I don't fuck with us. Because we so full of shit, we're so opinionated on some shit that we created. We created that funk.
Yeah, black people, we come from the world. We come from the world of black people, us, the roots, black folks. We come from the world of, we have done so much with so little, so long, that we can do anything with nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right.
That's the real, dude. That's the real. Where Rodney go?
That's who we are.
Yeah. That's who we are.
Man, you know I know that shit.
Of course.
But I got to get some fire started up in this motherfucker, and I fired it
you
up.
So fucking started
I fired it up like shit. A motherfucker.
You just
I got
Charles. When I said, did you get my
money? I got Charles Green. I got that motherfucker on fire, so I know I'd get this motherfucker here. And Rodney fuck around and asked the right question. I said, oh, here it comes. I've been on job. I never was 1964 or something like that. That motherfucker, he ain't changed that goddamn much. I know what fire his ass up. Oh, good. I love it. And Tony Coleman, I mean, Tony Coleman ain't nothing but, you know, he don't take nothing to fire his ass up. But man,
no,
I'm telling you.
This is good, guys.
Man. But we got to really do something, man, and hope this pandemic and stuff break out, man. Charles, you got your shots yet?
No, I'm trying to get them now. My wife's got both of hers. She's done already.
Yeah, I want to say because that'll be the next thing.
I get my second one tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
I get my second one tomorrow.
Oh, you get the second one tomorrow? Oh, okay, you're done.
See, over here in Germany, where they made the shit, we hardly got in it. It was like either 7% or 10% of the German people ain't got no vaccination. We ain't got no medicine over here.
Because y'all ain't hearing the music right.
They selling the shit up to Israel and everywhere else. They selling the shit. We're talking about taking care of our own. They take care of other motherfuckers. You know, here I am 71 years old and can't get a goddamn shot. You know?
Well, you still have dual citizenship, don't you?
Yeah. But still, it's not in our area. Well, okay, I'm 71.
You still got dual citizenship. You still got dual citizenship, don't you?
But the see, the problem is,
you got
to have something wrong with you, like a bad heart or some shit like that, to get up in the line. See.
Mm-hmm.
So that, you know, that's the problem. You know, so it's a rough thing.
Rodney's had both of his. He's had both of his shots.
Yeah, yo, Rodney.
Yeah, I'm all vaccinated up.
Man, I'm really, really not liking you much at all. not much at all.
Yeah,
you know, when we see each other, I'm sure we'll get along just great.
Oh man, as always, I'm not sure we will. I ain't worried about it. I'm all done, visored up. I'm all been hooked up, and I'm ready to go.
That's cool, man.
I'm ready to go.
I'm waiting for my shit.
Well, don't let them wait too long.
Yeah, I'm trying to get
it. No choice. It's nowhere that we.
Hey,
can
and
go,
you
though.
Know, and to give then to give people kind of, I mean, because you know, I myself I'm a holistic type of guy. You know, I mean, it's one of the things I don't really just kowtow to being able to do. Things that that is being instructed for me to do. So it's one of the things where I was reluctant
and at the same time was, you know, was doing research, because I'm the type of person that if I'm going to ask you to do something, I'm going to research on it and I'm going to do it myself and see how it made me feel or how it works for me before I introduce it to you or even suggest you to do it. And I have doctors in the family. I have nurses in the family. And from that, you know, they all understand my position, you know, as being a world traveler and being out there and being, you know, as an entertainer that I am. It's one of the things that, you know, they all, you know, very concerned about, you know, me traveling and doing things. So they give me, you know, all the information and feed me, kind of prepare me and try to, you know, kind of protect me from anything that they think that is going to, you know, physically harm me. So it's one of the things that even when this vaccine and they was talking about it and they was going through the Moderna side and then they was going through all the different, you know, visors, Pfizer side. And, you know, before while they was putting it together, it was one of the things that my people were doing research as well as I was doing research. I read into the conspiracy theories. I heard all the little different things that was going on. And then my actual sister's son, who is an actual doctor, Adrian, Dr. Adrian Buckner, down in Johnson City, he said, Rodney, he said, you know, I think I done got it to a, you know, to a point where I can give you a comfort zone. I done took it. You know, I followed your lead. I took it. I did the research on it. I even, you know, went under the microscope and kind of mapped it out. And he said, you know, that visor situation is very good. You know, do the visor, and I want you to go in and do your shot. Well, when my nephew told me to do that, I couldn't believe I was safe, because this was someone who I've raised, first of all. And then this was someone that I know that would not tell me to do something that would give me harm. So I went in and he told me a lot of the things. He said, you know, your arm gonna be sore. Man, I went in and took the shot. And I used to sit there and say, well, dang, why ain't these? I don't see these guys flinching or nothing. And sure enough, when I went in there, the lady said, what arm would you like it in? I said, I'll put it in my left arm. Right? Mm-hmm. She put a Band-Aid on there. And I turned around and looked at my brother. And then I felt her putting a Band-Aid across where she shot me. And I turned around and I said, when you going to give me the shot? She said, I already did. Now, did I have any symptoms? No. My arm wasn't sore, nothing. I didn't. For that first week, everything that they were saying that, you know, was supposed to happen, hey, man, I ain't had none of that. Everything was
cool. Which one did you get?
I got Pfizer, and I recommend the Pfizer. You know,
that's one that's made here that we can't get.
Don't forget the McDermott. I mean, forget that.
Pfizer's made here in Germany.
Yeah, well, I already
know. My sister-in-law has the other one.
Well, I did that in the second week when I went to get my second shot. I got that. I ain't had no headaches. All that stuff that they were saying, I ain't felt none of that.
Yeah, but my wife didn't have any symptoms either. None.
But the one thing I want to say is that, I mean, I'm in great shape. I didn't have, I go get checkups. I get, make sure that, you know, everything is cool. Matter of fact, you know, I mean, shoot, my doctors and them giving me, they sit up there saying my insides is like a 19-year-old child. So the bottom line is one of the things where, you know, it's basically dealing with your immune system and all these people with, you know, preconditioned, you know, health conditions and stuff like that. Is, you know, basically, you know, those are the things that you got to really watch after, because a lot of times it's one of the things where it's something that might be going on with you. In spite of what you think you're getting with the, you know, with the shot, it's something else that might be going on with you. So the best thing that I would suggest is for a person to go to their primary doctor, get some blood work, find out
what's going on. My blood work is excellent right now.
There you go. And get some blood work and find out what's happening. And then from that point, go ahead and take your shot.
You see, and you should be fine. It would be great.
Hey, I'm just waiting for it.
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
I'm healthy.
There you go.
Now, if you were here at 71, you would have been had your shot.
Oh yeah, you would have been had the shot. See, because you're much older than me. You know, I'm a young buck. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm 65 and I got mine.
Yeah, see, I don't understand.
Rodney, you're really pushing the limit. You're really pushing the limit. See? Okay. All right, man. No, this, we keep on trying to find a doctor and everything, trying to find out what's going on and where we can go and when. But, so far, it ain't no word yet, Ain't no word yet.
Hey, man, what's going on? Why don't you call Bruno Mars? He'll help you out.
Yeah. He'll give you some of that 24-karat bullshit.
Y'all got my lady up here laughing.
Hey, Bruno. Yeah,
she knows the truth. She knows the truth when she hears it.
Tony, come and don't forget that I have all the connections here. I'll kick your ass off this damn station in the heartbeat.
Amen. Listen to this. Fuck Bruno Mars, you and everybody else that think he's more important than us.
There you go. Coleman, don't make me write you a letter.
There you go. He talking about writing the Congress.
Now, what I respect is the fact that Bruno Mars know that what we was throwing down, it was the gauntlet. And he said, I don't give a shit what my generation of people is doing. I want to do, first of all, what he grew up doing, okay? Because he used to be the damn lead singer for his dad and his mom, and hell, they didn't sing nothing but our funk and our shit.
Right.
Over in Hawaii. As a matter of fact, I saw a little dude perform, and I thought it was a karaoke show.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, look here. Here's the deal. This is what's going on. This has been happening from the beginning of time. Here's what's going on. What's going on is this. I'm going to have a rooster contest for the loudest crowing rooster. And I'm going to have a rooster contest for the loudest crowing rooster. Okay. Your rooster. Okay. Your rooster. Yeah, he got a little deep voice. Okay. Waldo's rooster. Okay. You got it. Hey, you, Tony Coleman rooster. I don't have a rooster. I got a duck, and I got the duck. He said, "Man, this is a rooster contest. Why y'all bring let him bring the duck? What check this? I throw him in the duck. The duck sound like a rooster. Now that's some shit we can do."
God damn right.
Damn real. Sell a duck rooster.
Oh, I guess you did it with Elvis Presley. You did it with Justin Timberlake. Same bullshit. Motherfucking Nick Black jumping like, "He's great, I love him." And then you got black people do the shit. Well, we used to that. We like the white shit because it's different.
All right. Yeah. So that's that.
Yep.
Don't do that.
Yep. Anytime that they gonna tell me that Justin Timberlake is music is R&B, I know something's wrong.
What? You don't think Justin Timberlake's music is R&B? Man, you've been eating too much of that damn Vegas food, man. Come on, you know Timberlake is on it.
He's on what? Steroids?
Well, he's on something.
Because he sure ain't on R&B.
But wait a minute. Look, look here. Check this out. Charles,
what?
You remember the show called This Is Your Life?
Yeah.
Well, This Is Your Life. Jerry Preston from Mesa.
What's up? There he is. Jerome!
What's up, boy?
Come on, Romy, Rome!
What's God up, baby?
Damn, boy, look at here. This is what I'm talking. See, the world knows. See, the world is calling out to us right now.
That's God crazy.
Damn. What up,
Tyler Glenn? What's up, homie?
I'm good, man. What's up, baby?
Jerome, oh, man. Not much, man. What's up, TC? Rodney.
What's up, man? Damn.
Good, man.
Jerome, what's up, got over there and fuck, man. We're trying to help him out. We need to do something, man. It's bad, man.
Right, right. Yeah. I tell you what, funk will never die. I don't care what people do with the drum machines and the computers and stuff. One day these damn computers are gonna fail and they're gonna say, hey, where the funk boys at? And they gonna need us old school niggas to show them what to do.
That's right.
That's right. Funk will never die.
I know Charles still chop wood. I still chop wood.
I'm chopping some serious wood on him, boy.
Yes, sir.
I'm chopping the head.
That's what we're talking
about. You can bring that hip hop shit in there if you want to. You're going to get
better. That's what we're talking about. Funk don't never die. We just multiply.
It ain't going to never die.
We multiply. We don't die.
And it's crazy. See, it's crazy because I love me some hip hop. You know what I mean?
Me too. Like, me too. But when they bring it, everything is starting to turn to ain't nothing but the phones. I mean, they don't even need drum machines and stuff anymore. Everything is put on a phone now. If you got an iPhone, you can put a full orchestra thing on your phone and play it from your phone.
Yes, I do all the time.
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah. But Waldo said we need to get some of that new technology and put it with our shit. And then we might impress him.
Waldo, go get you a Maceo sample and then play.
Hey, you know, let me say this. This is real serious right here. Now, I run a studio and I got nothing but hip hop all day, 24/7, right? And but every time they come in and I'm mixing one of my records or something like that, man, the first thing, soon as I push play, they go, oh shit, that's that real shit. Now how come they call it the real shit?
Yeah,
but the executives for some reason
just call it shit.
It's shit. Exactly.
It's because they drank the Kool-Aid, Charles. You saw that cup.
But the hip hop community loves it though.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
They love it.
I mean, now, the whole world is now programmed
and asking for it. No. But if you put it in their face, they're gonna jump on it like a fat man.
There you go.
Yeah.
The whole world is programmed. You know, media programs the world to those who are weak. You know, we're strong individuals. We're strong black men. I know I am. I do me. I don't do nobody else.
No, I don't either. You know? That's what I just got to cuss him about.
See, I'm one of them strong black men that'll bite your head off. I'm like a pit bull, Cane Corso, Rockwilder, all that. I mean, I stand up. Right. And you know, Charles, you know how that's we do from Nashville. We'll play Maplewood, Pearl High, all that. But see, here's the thing. A lot of people are brainwashed by the media.
Yeah.
They drinking that Kool-Aid.
It's a brainwashing. And of course, if that's cool, then they're just like sheep, ready to go to slaughter, just like the Bible says.
There you go.
Yeah. Yes.
There you go.
See, I'm a leader. We're leaders. I don't follow, I lead.
Me too.
I know TC's a leader. I know Charles is a leader. I know Waldo's a leader. And I know Rodney's a leader. See, we're leaders.
That's right, bro.
All day long.
You got tons of followers out there. That's why.
Yeah.
There you go.
It was hard for me to follow the best of the best. We
watered down versions of being black. They watered down.
I always told Richard, I'll be with you. I won't follow you, but I will. I'll be with you. I will be on your side.
There you go. There you go.
I might even step in front of you a couple of times. Sorry, but.
I, when I was with Maceo and them, they used to tell me Rabbit. They called me Rabbit because I was all over the place. They said, Rabbit, get back. Yeah, I said, hey, this day, I was born on this motherfucker. Yeah, exactly. Who the fuck you think you talking to? That's I was born on this. I was born and raised on this. The stage raised me. So, but I mean, I'm at home.
You know what? I would love to see Jerry Preston and Charles Glenn on stage together. God damn it. And then get me and Rodney up there.
Shit, I'm already there. See, Charles, you better tell him something.
Get me up there.
Charles ain't. I'm the one in front of Charles.
Yeah, I don't go nowhere without RT.
Well, see, I need to be beside you.
put funky fat back TC Coleman jump, on the boy. Backbone and let's roll one then. Let's roll a big doobie right now and smoke that.
Yeah.
Roll it on down. Man. That's funny, man. It's so good to have all y'all cats on here, man.
Man.
Charles, you and Jerry Preston went to school together, didn't you?
We went to St. Vincent de Paul together when we was like babies, second, third grade, that kind of shit.
Okay.
Yeah. We knew each other back in the cradle days.
sure did. Like
then, here's what happened.
Then
I think we was both around 14 or 15. I was playing at a place called down on Jefferson. We both played at a place called what's that damn place on Jefferson Street? Not the modern era, the Elks Lounge.
Elks, yeah.
My band was playing there, Charles's band. When I looked over and said, Charles Glenn, he said, Jeff Preston. And I looked and he was playing bass. I'm like, I'm playing bass. I said, oh, shit. And we became like, we never got into rivalry, like angry, but we was like, okay, well, your band playing, my band playing too. Yeah, you know? Y'all better bring that funk. And we brought that funk. They brought that funk. We brought that funk. Now, one time, they stanked us. They put a stanking on us and had it
fall. Put a spanking on them on the festival.
Charles, you told me that story when we were down
there. That's him. Yeah. Exactly.
You told me that story and showed me the park.
Yeah. Oh, no. It was a true story. They put a spank on us.
We was riding around. Matter of fact, hold on.
Got my hat.
Waldo, matter of fact, that's when we was riding around Nashville and we was dropping the damn lyric to Funk Generation.
Sure was.
Okay.
We was creating Funk Generation when we was down there in Nashville and Charles was showing me his roots and we was dropping that shit down that end.
And Nashville was rocking. Nashville's been rocking ever since. The days, you know Waldo, you know, back in the days of the Delma Rocker Club when my mom used to run that place down Jefferson Street. All the show business, all the big people before they got big, Little Richard, James Brown, the Temptations, Elvis Presley was there. I was a baby. I was the little kid in the cradle because my mama didn't have nobody to babysit me. I was there. I was running around in that little rolling chair. When I was like 18 months, they're like, who is this little kid out here? That's little Jerry. That's Betty Sue's son. And he loved that music. As long as that music was kicking, I'm all over the place. But see, that's our roots though. That we cut from gospel, funk,
there you go,
jazz, R&B, rock and roll.
Preach.
Yeah.
Man, we did it all.
Country.
Yes, right. Huh? Country. TC said country.
Country too.
That's right. Go on, Deacon. Yeah. Preach. Teach that young boy.
It started from the cradle. I'm talking about literally from the cradle.
There you go.
There you go.
And look at us. Don't we look good?
I think we sound.
Let me read something that somebody put in the chat. They said, okay. Unfortunately,
is all about marketing in today's society. What you can sell, it takes a mixture of both.
Yeah, exactly.
Precisely.
I totally agree.
Whoever wrote that, you need to sound
like Bruno, or y'all ain't got the so and so, or why your hand claps ain't loud enough. Ain't got nothing to do with none of that shit.
Right. It's all about the market.
Hey, I just told management 2 days ago when he called me with an idea. I said, no, that's a horrible idea because now you're putting it back on me. You know what I need to do. No, the team is weak. I said, if you can't sell this shit, the team is weak. It ain't got nothing to do with the music.
That's right.
We've been done with the music a long time ago.
There you go.
If the team becomes as strong as the music, we're gonna win. Easily.
All day long. We'll win every
Bruno
day.
Bruno Mars.
We'll win every day.
Fuck them damn songs. The team is strong. One of the best fucking teams in the business.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. We will win every day.
That's so strong of a team that it makes a veteran to another veteran say, you need to sound like this dude. That's how strong of a team that shit is.
Yeah.
That's strong marketing right there.
I need to go, y'all. Jerome, you're in Nashville, right?
No, ain't none of them in Nashville. Jerry lives in Atlanta now.
Oh, okay. Hey, I gotta go, y'all. I'm gonna be in Atlanta. I thought you'd be there. I wanted to see you.
All right, man.
Okay. If you come through Atlanta, give me TC. I'll text you my phone number.
All right, cool. Hey, I love y'all. Okay. I love you, brothers.
Yeah, man.
Love you, brother.
All right, man. I'm sorry you gotta go. Bye, bitch. Anyway.
it took a bitch to say a business.
Do you want me to respond in a Waldo way or a Tony Coleman way?
Hey, so what,
baby?
The motherfucking bitch now.
So what? What?
This baby.
He just got you. That's my boy. He know how to do that.
I cut that motherfucker. So look at who got the controls in this motherfucker.
No.
Damn.
That motherfucker still out here trying to talk.
What
do you want, man? Didn't you say you had to go somewhere? What?
What'd you say, T?
So you be a black son of a bitch?
You gonna call me a black son of a bitch?
A son of a bitch? Black son of a bitch. Some of a bitch.
Yeah. For all you people, if anybody's on the air listening to us, like here where I am in Germany and everything, we know you ain't got a clue what we're saying or what the fuck we're talking about. But we are here in our living room, talking shit to each other.
Literally, about anything
and everything involving music, politics, ex-girlfriend, ex-wife, child support, whatever.
Ooh, let me get on child support.
Child support. Hell no! I always took care of my shit.
I don't know.
See, Jerome? See, this is what I'm saying.
We can't let him talk about child support of Bruno Mars.
Let Bruno Mars have some kids. God damn it.
Let Bruno Mars pay some child support. I don't pay no damn child support. My kids are grown. Yeah.
What I'm going to say is applies to you.
I'm willing to bet that everybody on this broadcast.
If you have a dream about calling me motherfucker or something again, you better wake up and holler after my ass, motherfucker, you. But your brother Mars living at Bruno Mars. I don't know that Bruno and them.
Are you saying something?
What's
on
Potato chips.
Okay, Tony's gone out of the picture now. But you know, I salute you, Tony, wherever you are. You know, here's to Tony Cohen, some of a bitch. But anyway.
some of a bitch. You gonna play some Tony?
Oh, Lord, man. But look here. Man, it's been really, really nice.
Yeah, man, it's been a pleasure, man.
And I don't know exactly when, cause I got to see what Tony's got lined up. But I'm gonna get Jerry on a session by himself in a couple of weeks. There, you know, we got to see what's all lining up. Tony's a little, he's younger than I am, but he's kind of slow up, you know. But anyway, And he's moving, you know, so he's got a lot of things going on. Going to Nashville to record and everything and blah, blah, blah. So, look here, man. If y'all ass ever get anywhere near where I is and don't call me up, because I'm bringing my goddamn horns with me wherever you at. I'm bringing my shit with John. When the last time I played with you? With me and Ray.
I allegedly have management that should be bringing me right to your door. So I'm waiting. On
just in case, you know, we're going to be waiting
just
a long
in case
time
he's
for that
listening.
Bullshit.
Just in case he's listening, Mr. My manager, I need to get to Waldo.
Wait a minute. Are you talking
gonna,
about,
we gonna be waiting a long time about, for that bullshit. He's still in New York shit.
Are we talking about our manager?
Oh, that's right.
Oh yeah. Damn. So I think he's supposed to be my manager too.
Ooh, oh shit. Well. But hell, he's the manager meeting.
No, hell no. You safe.
Get on mute.
You say. We wouldn't want to put you in no bullshit.
Ooh, damn. I need to get y'all out of it then, don't I?
Yes.
Hell yeah.
You know, I'm gonna speak out because you know I'm the rebel. You know.
There you go. Me too.
You know, they can say anything to me. I'm the damn rebel, you know, because I'll immediately jump in my spaceship and head back to my planet. I don't need to be in this damn place anyway.
Say, fuck these motherfuckers.
That's right.
Get the hell out.
That's right. And I'll take right on over, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, call it Sir Nose. Call it Sir Nose.
You know. Yeah, that's right. I'll just take
the call. All right, there you
go. I can't stand it.
Oh, my God.
One more time with Waldo. Oh.
But look here, you know this is supposed to be, I mean, there's no time limit, but this was supposed to be a 1 hour podcast. Yeah, we've been on here for three hours.
Hey.
Hey, bring us back with Jimmy. Get Jimmy Church ass on here so we can really go downtown. Him and Tyrone Smith.
We don't want to go that way.
Well, Waldo, it was a pleasure. It was a pleasure, man. I thank you for, you know, allowing me to come in and say a couple of things I'll see you soon.
Yep. Right.
Jerome, man, I'm looking forward.
The old music.
Come on down the line.
Hey, we're going to be down in Atlanta. Matter of fact, we got our station is getting ready to OzoneGoldRadio.com. You can get it.
I'll send Charles my telephone number, then you pass it on.
Yeah,
you,
okay? And he'll get it, and it's
on his Facebook page. Just go on OZone.
Oh yeah, it sure is. If you go on my Facebook page, it's on there. A 678 number. It's a 678.
No, I'm talking about the radio station. The radio station is on the OZone Facebook page.
Yeah. OzoneGoldRadio.com. Go ahead and lock into that, because we're getting ready to head down there, because we got a series of shows we're getting ready to do down there. Matter of fact, we're getting ready to do our new single that we're dropping, Ozone's new single, Ballers Walk. Cool. And we're getting ready to lock that in. That's getting ready to be a big campaign push for video and everything else, as far as the video directors, models, all kind of people who want to go ahead and do their own interpretation of the song, get it there, to get into the contest, the Ballers Walk contest, to be able to go ahead and get into our video that we're getting ready to shoot, and it's going to be down in Atlanta. So we're pulling it all together right now. So everything is looking great. So
Atlanta's opening up, so it's time, too.
Yeah, so it's time. So be looking Ozone Ballers Walk, new single coming out.
In the States, y'all starting to play music everywhere. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Matter of fact, we got a show that we're doing the 25th of April, right, Charles?
Yes.
Yeah. See, can't play nothing here but the radio.
Yeah. We're doing a thing with Slave.
Yes, yeah, Slave, you know, and all of us is down
we
there.
We still on lockdown over here.
Yeah, but y'all getting paid to be on lockdown too.
Real.
See, that's that hush money.
No, I mean, we're doing all right. You know, our restaurant has never been closed because we do a lot of carry out, you know.
We
get a lot of people and stuff. But still, I miss playing the music. You know, and the people here miss me playing the music as well. Yeah. And then we have other issues with the city that has stopped us from playing live music, which I have to say, so many people have complained, wrote to the newspapers and petitions and everything to the government here. And so many people are behind us, and we virtually haven't done anything but just sit back. And newspaper people are coming, and they are fighting for us and fighting. So we still fighting. And by the time this pandemic is over, maybe, you know, we'll have something. But
isn't y'all's TV and stuff still in production there? Like, you know, or is it just on rerun shit only? Because TV is in production big time. I mean, they shooting shit. Everybody's got masks on the new shows and everything now.
Yeah, but like we say, saxophone. You're not allowed to play saxophone. Because if you play saxophone, it blows out the air.
Oh shit!
So you can't get that air into the public. You understand?
Or
trumpet and stuff. You can't do that. They shut the churches down. No,
that was
you can't sing and stuff. You know?
Yeah,
it's crazy, man. It's really crazy. So, but we keep doing what we're doing, and we're still hanging in there, and hopefully everything come about. But if it ever happens where you all can get here, I have the ideal place to put on one of the biggest shows, which is, I won't say that.
Yeah, you might as well go on and put it together
We're doing it. Let's do it.
Yeah, you might as well put it together and just bring us there.
Let's do it.
Get your sponsors together and just go ahead and do it, and then you be the promoter and bring us there. You're directly in contact with the artists. So on that word, I got to go. I'll talk to y'all later, and y'all have a blessed one. And,
all right,
and,
T, take care, baby. You
know. Okay, we'll do. Y'all have okay, a
blessed Wait. You telling me you got to go so you can eat your big-ass Las Vegas lunch?
Oh, shit, we done sat and watched you eat a whole dinner.
No, wait a minute. First of all, ain't that a bitch? You didn't sit up here and eat ice cream, potato chips, sucker, and shit, and wipe the juice all off your face and shit.
He was biting, still wiping, Charles.
Like we say in Nashville,
he was eating these nuts.
Yeah. Look at you. And now you're going to sit up there and tell me I can't leave because I'm going to go to over here to probably one of and get, hell yeah, I'm gone. Wait a minute.
Go enjoy yourself. In the words of my oldest brother,
okay, Tony T.C. Kemp, all right, bye.
I got somebody here waiting on a session,
so I got to get going myself.
Yeah, man. Okay. It's been nice.
Charlie,
been
take nice. Care, baby.
Yeah, I love you,
we
man.
We all get together again. So, we just want to say, ladies and gentlemen, you have been here with the blues and funk legends, and we'll see you next Friday with somebody. Thank you, Jeff Preston, for coming by, and Woo! Sir Knows. So we'll see you next Friday. God bless you. Have a nice day.
We got to go a little further. I see big changes coming soon. We got to go a little further. The sunlight's coming through, yeah. Oh, oh yeah. Go a little further, yeah. Go a little further. Listen, the truth's not being told, the lies are taken, it's time to make that change. We didn't come here cause we wanted to, but since we're here, I think we'll just stay. We need to get out and vote, and make this world a better place, and get our fair share. John Deere would be just great.
Yeah, show respect, what's next? Get off our necks.
Love.
What's love if you force and flex? We ain't with it no more, so toss the checks. Can't be Martin now, Malcolm X. Breathe, just breathe, cause of death. Black and I'm proud, written across my chest. Lives been taken up off the decks. Matter of fact, I'm striving, cause effects. Stay blessed.
Is this the world we live in? Made of flames and blood? Masquerade, battles in the streets of home? Culture lends to see the view of your brother's life. Realities change when you take a step across the line. I can't breathe, he cried from the summer pavement. Mama, please. He begged for her to come and save him. Her warrior's heart took aim with flames of fire and lit the city.
Can't you understand? Our lives are being taken. We got to make that change. We didn't come here cause we wanted to, but since you brought us here, I think we'll just stay, yeah. We need to get out and vote, and make this world a better place, and get our fair share. We'll take the 40 acres, but you can keep the mule. A John Deere would be just great. Oh, oh. Got to go a little further. The sunlight's coming through, yeah. We got to go a little further. Well, well, well. Oh,
Mm-hmm.